Samsung think this new product will appeal to today's consumers who are looking for a television that's really, really huge? I mean, this thing is built like a f***ing Mack truck. You just really have to see it to believe it.
In other news, an important decision is sent up to the company's highest idiot. And an area mother doesn't see why Thai people need to make food so spicy. Today's Onion Review was sponsored by Bamboo Garden, voted the best family-owned Chinese restaurant in Idaho for 5 years running.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, you dial toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. It is the live Saturday edition. Joining you in studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And we've got a special guest here tonight, Mark. We don't normally do guests on Free Talk Live, but every now and then something comes up where we just feel like we've got to talk to somebody about it. And the situation that we've actually reported on, we talked about last night on Free Talk Live, between antiwar.com and Google, the search internet behemoth. Google appears to have targeted antiwar.com over some old web page, or at least one old web page that has been on the site for 11 years, about the some of the pictures from the Abu Ghraib abuses, the detention center, if you want to call it that, the torture center in Iraq from over a decade ago. It's really hard to believe that it's been that long, but it has. And so some of the photos from that abusive situation, that horrifying situation, have been featured over at antiwar.com. And Antiwar also was doing Google AdSense, where, you know, you can have Google put advertising on your website. And then if people click on those links, then Google will send you a check. And apparently the check that Google had been sending was fairly decent to antiwar.com. So it's kind of hurt a little bit. Angela Keaton is with us from antiwar.com. It's apparently it was a bit of a hit to the budget there over at antiwar.com, which, by the way, has been sort of difficult raising funds ever since the FBI targeted antiwar.com a few years ago. Is that pretty much an accurate recap, Angela?
That's pretty good, yes. For antiwar.com, yeah, we've cut our budget way back from our peak years, which kind of corresponded, I think, a bit with the Ron Paul financial mania. So, but we're grateful for every dime. We keep the budget really tight, and we want to keep the quality going, because what's important about antiwar.com is we are constantly working. My boss and Jason Ditz and everyone else, Scott Horton, everyone is working right now so that there's a fresh page tonight, every night at midnight. So for us, every dollar matters, and our ads have always been unobtrusive. And we also, you know, we take ads from outsiders, you know, libertarian organizations and other things too. But we've been using Google AdSense, which really helped our budget, just like things like Amazon Affiliate. And I realize, and I know this is important to point out for the Free Talk Live audience, since this is a very sensitive audience, but I realize, yes, probably doing things like Amazon Affiliates and Google AdSense is probably in some ways maybe contributing to these relationships with large corporations that don't usually have the stones to stand up to government pressure, whether it be NSA or hosting WikiLeaks, hosting WikiLeaks and other things that some of these corporations have been implicated in. So I realize, you know, and to listeners and to readers of antiwar.com, I realize that there's a lot of complicated political and ideological issues here about what relationships are ethical, and we just try to do the best we can. But we're probably not, under any circumstances, now going to Google AdSense, because it became a game of what my boss described as whack-a-mole. The Abu Ghraib pages were one issue, and then 2 days later, an article by a well-known anti-war activist named Chris Ernesto on Ukraine, which was this article several weeks old, also became an issue. And it just, first off, you know, it's not, you know, antiwar.com is done, there's static and dynamic pages. It's done, though, the very old style HTML. And this is not just a case of just yanking an ad or just shifting something here or there. Mm-hmm. It's fairly complicated to run the site and move it around, because it's hard to change it up, because it's not like we can ever really shut down. But also, there's just
I mean, just before you go on there, it was my understanding that Google had actually caught wind of what was happening through a Gawker article, and so there was a little bit of publicity that surrounded you guys sort of putting it out there about how Google was pulling out. Essentially, they stopped stopped your participation in their program, and then you guys received an email from someone at Google saying it, which sounded apologetic. It sounded like they were sorry that this had happened in such a quick manner. Apparently, there's supposed to be a 72-hour window where they will notify a site and say, hey, you know, you guys have this page. There's stuff on it that violates our terms of service. You need to do something about it. And then they're supposed to give you some time to do that. Apparently, they didn't do that. So the person was apologetic about that and said that they would reinstate AdSense once the change had been made, which ostensibly you guys did, and then expected them to reinstate it. And that's when the whack-a-mole thing happened. That's when they came up with, oh, well, we can't reinstate you because of this page. And then they cite this page about the Ukraine situation.
And this is all hard news, right? Like, this isn't, right. In any way...
It's not a gore site.
Yeah. Gratuitous or prurient or sexual or whatever.
I don't know if you saw the Ukraine page, Mark, it was a picture of dead bodies that were stacked up. I mean, this was the result of violence. It wasn't even actual violence that was being pictured there.
Well, I think usually that's what happens with pictures anyway, is the result of violence, not actual violence, right?
Well, I mean, you could have a picture of someone being shot or harmed.
Oh, you mean like that famous life picture, the time picture with the guy
from
getting
Vietnam.
Executed, right?
Yeah.
Like, so yeah, I mean, I get how these aren't the most pleasant images to look at, but they're not there for in a gratuitous way. They're in a hard
news reporting.
Way.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, it seems to me that this should be allowed, but Google can obviously have whatever kind of policies they want to.
It's their business, but the problem is that in this country here specifically. And I suspect that's what we're dealing with mostly, is that people don't want to see what the real news is. Mm. They want very badly to stick their heads in the sand and not realize what, what's going on around the world. And antiwar.com is very, they have a specific mission right in the name.
Anyway, Angela, I just wanted to make clear my understanding of what had happened is they, you guys were willing to jump through the first hoop, and then they went ahead and put up a second one, and essentially, the position from anti-war at this point is, screw this, we'll find another option.
Well, we'd avoided having ads on that site, and the only reason why there was some code for ads way at the bottom was because after, we didn't realize this, moving the site around and making it bigger and having it host in different places, wasn't so cleanly transferred, but it was never a place that had the typical ads. If you look at the site, we have the giant ad above antiwar.com, and we have a side ad in the corner right below the fresh blog listings. I mean, our ads tend to be kind of discreet, but they were never that. But those ads were never on the Abu Ghraib page. I mean, that was meant to just be photographs.
Okay, so they've come back at you. They said, pull this other page down, and you've said, they didn't say pull the page down, which was one of the gripes I had with the article that came up, because there was another libertarian actually here in New Hampshire who wrote an article, and actually a listener of Free Talk Live. He wrote an article saying that you guys were playing victim for the purpose of asking for more donations. And while I don't agree with Google's policies here, and I think that they are written in a way that is incredibly vague, we actually went down the violence policy that they have, and essentially anything that's considered disturbing, there's like this huge window, this very large loophole of the word disturbing content, which of course could mean really anything at all. They can use whatever excuse they want to take a site down. But Ethan Glover had said on his blog post that he felt like you guys weren't being entirely honest. And I have to agree that the way this article is written by Eric Garris here from March 20th, which was yesterday, he says, this morning they contacted us demanding that we remove this article. And then he links to the one about the Ukraine situation. And they didn't actually demand you remove the article. They demanded that you remove their advertising from the article. Isn't that right?
Well, I guess it's a semantical difference, though. I mean, after all, that the photograph without that article or the article without the photograph is kind of, well, wouldn't be the same thing now, would it?
Well, no, I agree with that.
The life under a market, this is what a few people I think have a little difficulty understanding. So what, Google's a private corporation? When you're living under markets you know, your PR and your customer relations and your reputation are what matters. And every, you know, we're clients of, you know, we had a business relationship with these people. That's why, I mean, people want to make this somewhat more conspiratorial and political than it is. But the fact is, this is business. And we have every right to complain and every right to say that we're not, you know, being treated right as clients. And we don't have to do business with Google AdSense, mm-hmm. and we won't be.
What else is out there?
Other businesses shut forward.
You said that other businesses are out there. I don't know what they are. I'm just wondering, like, where else can you go besides Google? They seem so dominant in the field. And you've got time. You can stick with us, as I understand
sure.
it, right? All right, more
yes.
with Angela Keaton here in moments. The toll-free number. Also, I think she wants to talk about some other anti-war-related stuff. So we'll get into that, too. 855-450-FREE, because there's a lot of news over at antiwar.com, always. More on the way here on Free Talk Live's Live Saturday show.
Indefinite extension of the human lifespan is coming. But is it coming soon enough for you and me? That's the $80,000 question. I say $80,000 because that's what it costs to have your head cryonically frozen by Alcor. I've committed to do it. I got a life insurance policy, and I made them the beneficiaries. Bam, my best shot at living forever. Interested? Contact them at alcor.org, ALCOR.ORG. Mention my name, and I get a free year of membership.
How fast are new Allegra gel caps?
I didn't know you got a cat fast.
How strong are new Allegra gel caps?
10 more lots to go strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gives you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms in just 1 hour. 2 times faster than Claritin and stays strong for 24 hours.
It's relief when the pollen's off the charts strong, even in the convertible.
New Allegra gel caps. Nothing's faster. Nothing's stronger. Guaranteed or your money back. Visit Allegra.com. Use only as directed.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
If you're looking for work, the person you are applying to may be even more nervous than you are. And the way things are now, your references have never been more important. Here are 3 tips. First, know that employers are checking. Every hire is under the microscope these days. Second, they won't just be checking references you provide. Figure that all of your ex-employers will get a call and be asked, would you hire him or her again? Third, assume you will be Googled. So before you apply, remove all those party animal photos from your Facebook page. Even if you're not in the job market, effective communication skills have never been more important, with money and attention so scarce now. For more tips for job seekers and getting better results in all your day-to-day communication, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
The 3 most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are 1, share 1 episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition of the program. Antiwar.com is under fire from Google for some of the content that's been on the site for a decade. Apparently, it hasn't been a problem up until this week. We'll give you more information about that. We've got Angela Keaton on the line with us from antiwar.com, the toll-free number here. If you'd like to comment, plus there's some more sort of anti-war-related stuff, more not just about the site, but about the issues of the world that we can talk about, too. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number.
I've never really paid that much attention to expensive wines, but we recently got a shipment of wine from Cameron Hughes, and it's chwine.com if you want to go check it out. And I was really surprised at how good wine is. I just didn't know that much about it. I wasn't willing to spend $70 to $100 for good wine
per
bottle.
No, me neither.
But if you go to Cameron Hughes at chwine.com, you'll find these same bottles at between $12 and $20 a piece. The reason is because what Cameron does is he goes to wineries around the country, usually mostly in California, but some around the world, and he buys their overstock. He then bottles it up in his own bottles with lot numbers on it, so you don't know where it came from. It's just a really high-end wine. And we had a really great time. We got six different bottles. They were all wonderful, and I think you'll probably enjoy it too. And I talked to Cameron, and I got a special code to get free shipping. And this really matters when you're talking about liquids.
Yeah, that's significant.
It's a significant savings. So please go to chwine.com. Take a look. Get your favorite type of wine. Treat yourself, because you're going to get this at a significantly lower price. Basically, you're talking about wines that score 90s and above, and they're as low as $12 to $20 a piece, plus free shipping. chwine.com, there's a microphone in the upper left-hand corner. Click on that. Use coupon code FTL, and you'll get free shipping. chwine.com, the microphone in the upper left-hand corner, coupon code FTL, free shipping.
I'm pretty sure Cameron said there were some that were more expensive than $20, Mark, but they're all a cut far, far lower than, you know, what they would be.
There may
normally
be. The ones that I was poking around on there, I noticed basically those. That was the price range.
You saw?
Yeah.
Okay. So, yeah, chwine.com, code FTL.
It says here the average bottle cost is about $15.
Okay, that's pretty good. So chwine.com, code FTL, gets you the free shipping, but that's a limited time offer. I don't know how many more weeks that's going to be.
Oh, man, they just upped the exclusive offer, too. It's there's also an extra 20% off selected bottles with the coupon code. So free shipping and an extra 20% off select bottles.
All right, very good. So check it out. Let's continue here. We've got Angela Keaton with us from antiwar.com. The controversy we discussed in quite a bit of detail last night on Free Talk Live, really kind of poring over Google's policies about, you know, what do they allow, what do they disallow. Basically, the violence policy there is written so broad, it's so nebulous, that they can essentially apply it to anything that they want to. And out of nowhere, they just decided to send you guys a violation saying, hey, we're pulling your AdSense account because they don't like the content on a page that's been on the site for a decade. Presumably, someone complained about it. Maybe that person was in the government. Who knows? But now you guys are looking for other options. Who has stepped forward and offered to compete?
Smaller agencies. I mean, I've always gotten offers from other things. They're, you know, people, because of my emails out there as the business persons, you know, for antiwar.com. So people just randomly will send me things like, hey, consider this. And I mean, I kept them, but the fact was, you know, and this is laziness somewhat on my part, and a lot of us fall into this, but like the Google products, like Google products are really easy and convenient and cheap to use. So we got kind of hooked on that. It didn't have to be that way, and it certainly doesn't have to be that way. And there are other, of course, search engines and getting away from Gmail and Google Hangout. There's lots of alternatives. Like with Google Hangout, there's Fiend Phone.
Mm. Well, Fiend Phone's nice, but it doesn't really compete with Google Hangout because Fiend Phone doesn't have video, and it's also not particularly easy, at least at this point, to use Fiend Phone for group communications. But, you know, Google Hangout does have other options. Of course, they usually come from, you know, other competitors that are also big mega corporations like Skype. But yeah, I don't really know of much else besides that.
Yeah, so this isn't a death blow for antiwar.com, because I always thought this was a terrible thing once Google says, sorry, not going to do business with you anymore.
I mean, if the FBI, the FBI lawsuit and the FBI surveillance hasn't changed us, it's just made us more obnoxious and unintentionally transparent. If you've ever witnessed antiwar.com staff meetings on Twitter, usually there's a breakout of a skirmishing among SCAF on policy right there in front of everyone. It's a huge inconvenience. It's like having the transmission on your car die. It's a huge inconvenience.
Yeah, for sure.
But you can get the transmission rebuilt, or you can get a used transmission, whatever. But there are definitely options. We just have, be more creative. But what's great in a market, and the beauty of the markets, is that there are lots of businesses, as Free Talk Live and others can attest, that are share good values and want to advertise, in addition to these agencies that, are willing to work with our content. So it's not – it is driving us crazy in terms of the things that will have to be changed, certainly. But – readers have stepped forward. It's gotten people to be really creative, like our friends Bitcoin Not Bombs. They're doing a contest with Google with the play. This is from Dan Sanchez from Mises Academy, came up with the hashtag Don't Expose Evil. And this has made for a great Don't Expose Evil meme contest at Bitcoin Not Bombs. And you can see this is the first it's up there posted from yesterday. It's a pro peace meme contest, and you're going to see some really, really great, talented and creative things coming out of this. So is it annoying? Yes. Is it really frustrating because of all the silliness surrounding it? Absolutely. But no, if the FBI didn't knock us down, Google certainly isn't, for crying out loud. I mean, rantiwar.com, the market has decided, for whatever reason, that we're staying online, and we are.
Yeah, you guys have a very recognizable name, and I think it's wonderful that somehow you scoop that up before essentially all these organizations that might purport to be for peace but really aren't.
Well, that's to the credit of our CEO and founder, Eric Garris, who was a member of Rothbard's Radical 2 Caucus and the LP, for people who keep track of that sort of thing. So, it was smart, but that came out of the Clinton era, because Bill Clinton was a particularly effective warmonger.
Yeah, by the way, Mark, I was just looking, antiwar.com has been registered since 1995, so somebody really did snag that a long time ago. It's been there 20 years.
So what problem did Google have with these Abu Ghraib, I don't know how to properly pronounce this word, Abu Ghraib pictures? Why? I mean, these are old news. What problem did they have with these pictures?
According to the email from my boss, which looked a bit computerized, that it violated the gore and violence content, and they had lists of things that were acceptable and not acceptable. I have no idea why. It could have just been some officious person, going by and saying, oog. It could have been whatever. I mean, we don't know who made the complaint or why, and we probably never will, but that supposedly is what it violated.
Yeah, and as we pointed out last night, Mark, you weren't here for this, but Daryl pulled up Google's policy, and it is just written in such a nebulous manner that anything that's considered offensive can be labeled as violence. So even though, this is clearly news reporting on a worldwide important event that was, pretty shocking to a lot of people and needs to be heard about, Google just decided, that's in violation of our policy. And I don't think they would do the same thing for, like the U.S. military's page, I suspect. And there was even contradictions right there in their violence policy. Like, it's okay to show boxing matches, but fighting is against the rules. It just doesn't make any sense. There's more coming up here with Angela Keaton.
Measles is activating on a mass scale, now due to the vaccines and iron poisoning. All symptoms, disease, and deaths are due to measles and iron, not just rash and flu-like symptoms, as the officials claim. Measles requires a host with iron to replicate. Iron intake is at an unprecedented level. Deaths and hospitalizations are set to soar now in 2015. This is the extermination plan, people. For further information, go to unveilingthem.com. UNVEILINGthem.com. Unveilingthem.com.
This is Rick Osick, president of Famous Footwear. Our company is working together with the March of Dimes through March for Babies to raise money and awareness about the serious problem of premature birth in the U.S. As a business leader, I know that babies born very sick or too soon cost businesses billions of dollars each year, in addition to the emotional stress on employees and their families. That's why Famous Footwear is committed to raising funds to improve the health of moms and babies everywhere. Won't you please join us in the March for Babies? Start a team today at marchforbabies.org.
Free Talk Live.
They're the mafia. They function like the mafia. They think like the mafia. They hire people who think like the mafia. The only difference is they put on a front that there's something legitimate and legal and valid about all of it.
Well, there's no Don in this particular mafia. The Don is the majority of people who went out and voted and then put, you know, their new Don in place. And sometimes the Dons change and sometimes they don't. Incumbents are very difficult to unseat. And you know, but their henchmen stay in place the whole time. It's quite a sophisticated mob operation.
It is. Well,
it's the
mafia that is so successful and that has so brilliantly pulled the wool over people's eyes that they've actually gotten people to give them their children so the mafia can educate them into believing that they need the mafia.
Right. We have free indoctrination camps. I mean, school for you to send your kids to.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
LRN.FM needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think
you
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this
office. No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't gonna make...
Wait,
you wanna
come. Now. Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
Property. What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything that you want. Just dial toll-free here. It's the live Saturday edition. Though, if you've got a question for Angela Keaton of antiwar.com, she's with us here and probably going to stick with us for a little bit. So we've got time to get you in here. Again, toll-free number 855-450-FREE. We also have Skype, but if you Skype in, you won't be able to talk to Angela because she's on Skype. That's why she sounds so good. So if you've got a question for her, do call in toll-free 855-450-FREE. It doesn't have to be about the Google controversy. In fact, I think we pretty much have said all there is to say about that. But there are some other issues that she thought was important to discuss here tonight, so we'll do that. Plus, coming up, the Texas Bitcoin Conference. It's going to be happening. It's the second one. Mark, you and I, we were at the first one last year, and we're going to be back this year.
Yeah, it's going to be great.
Right? Broadcasting live from the event. It's happening, actually, in 1 week. So March 28th and 29th, that'll be our Saturday and Sunday shows next week. We'll be live from Austin at the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference. And, of course, Austin is actually the home to Scott Horton, who happens to be one of antiwar.com's favorite radio hosts. You guys used to actually employ Scott there, Angela, over at antiwar.com, and unfortunately, due to budget cuts, you couldn't continue doing that, but thankfully, Scott kept doing his show. He's just renamed it from Anti-War Radio to the Scott Horton Show, but it's pretty much the exact same show that it's always been, and it airs on LRN.FM 5 days a week. And I always noticed Anti-War is constantly promoting that, so I want to just say thanks for continuing to support Scott in whatever way you guys can.
Oh, we will continue to do that. Scott Horton is a unique talent, and the work that he does for the anti-war movement and for news is possibly one of the most important things that ever happens out. But in real life, I'm actually an honest to God fan of LRN. I listen to it constantly, and I think Daryl did such a great job last night. So we're just very, very grateful to have this service. But it goes to just one last point I wanted to make. I mean, mainstream news, oh my God, the monopoly of the mainstream news. But the thing is, you have shows like Free Talk Live. You have networks like LRN. Facebook. Oh, Facebook's everywhere. But you have Liberty.me. And the fact is there's lots of alternatives to Google, including search engines like DuckDuckGo. Just this real quick point. For those of you who are fans of one of the earlier left libertarians, Robert Anton Wilson, and read the science fiction book, The Illuminatus Trilogy, there's the great line about, what would they do if they get rid of all the chairs? Well, you'll sit on your rear. You'll sit on your rear end is what will happen. So that's the same situation here. Okay, so what if Google pulls all their AdSense forever from antiwar.com? Fine, we'll just find someone else.
And I imagine, I'm hoping at least, donations have been up a little bit since all of this controversy. I mean, there certainly has been some publicity surrounding Google's sort of assault on anti-war, and I hope that people have stepped forward, and certainly they can go to antiwar.com and do that. By the way, I want to also mention the Texas Bitcoin Conference. I don't know if Scott Horton's going to be there, but he lives in Austin. That's sort of why I brought him up. And actually, I had the chance to meet Scott. He was actually at the Liberty Forum, which was the New Hampshire event that happened a couple weeks ago, or three weeks ago at this point, which was kind of fun. It was finally cool to meet him. So you get to meet us, Mark and I. We're going to be at the Texas Bitcoin Conference. Again, that's March 28th and 29th. Use code FTL when you go to TexasBitcoinConference.com and get your tickets online. Now, Mark, we need to find out when ticketing closes on the website, because I imagine there's going to be some day coming up within the next week that tickets will only be available at the door of the event. And at that point, I don't know if you're going to get a discount by telling the person at the door the code FTL. So
seems unlikely.
You probably
it?
Need to get the tickets sooner rather than later. TexasBitcoinConference.com. Lots of great speakers lined up. The second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon, and also some of the ticket price goes to benefit Sean's Outpost. It's a very affordable conference. Only $150 for the tickets. You save $25 by using code FTL at TexasBitcoinConference.com. We'll see you at the Moody Theater in Austin next weekend. So, Angela, what other things are going on in the world that you thought might be important to talk about here on Free Talk Live that are, being covered over at Anti-War?
Well, one is the anniversary of the Iraq invasion, which it completely has changed. I mean, if you think about things about what's makes people aware that we're an empire, certainly Iraq. It's just absolutely the most horrible thing that happened in the 21st century is the most recent U.S. invasion of Iraq, an absolute horror, an absolute disgrace, and just a moral atrocity. So This is the time to really think about that.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff going around out right now claiming that Bush and company lied in order to get us into Iraq.
No.
Well, I've always kind of thought to myself that, that it's a mistake, right? Like there was some guy that was tortured by the Egyptian government, which is essentially a client state of the U.S., and they came up with some information that, was erroneous, that they had the yellow cake and all that stuff. Did lies go on? Or, what were the lies? What were the mistakes in this, Angela?
The lies over the mistakes. Dear God, the mistake was believing a damn thing any of these jerks could possibly have said. I mean, whatever made anyone think that George Bush and Dick Cheney were reasonable, moral, and ethical people? I mean, that to me just seems like complete self-delusion right there. It's just, people who are apologists for the war, or people who are sheepish about admitting just what a horrible atrocity they supported are going to say that they're mistakes. I mean, the weapons of mass destruction, really. I mean, a lot of these things I think had already been, the war propaganda and buildup have patterns. I mean, it's not as, as if we hadn't seen this kind of agitation before, why would we believe? Why should we have believed them? I mean, what was the?
Because people don't know
the
history. Essentially, I mean, that would be why. There's always this drum beating that goes on for war. I fell for it, Angela. I'm going to go ahead and say it right here. Early on, I fell for the whole Iraq thing, and then at some point, I realized, you know what? They're not just going in there to kick a little butt and leave. They're going to be there forever. And that's when I'm like, then I realize that U.S. foreign policy is messed up.
Yeah, but what made you think that Iraq was a threat to the U.S.? Like, what? Why did you think it was a good idea to go in there? What made you think that they were Saddam Hussein was a problem for us?
Well, I believe the yellow cake statements. I also, at the time there were, I remember on Glenn Beck they were talking about how Saddam had terrorist training facilities, including a jumbo jet fuselage and that sort of thing. There was also the Kufi and Hoo Hoo, whatever the heck Saddam's kids were named, and there were the rape rooms, which of course we never got to see pictures of those either. And so, I mean, you know, that's kind of adding to it. I'm not claiming that made them a threat. I'm just, that's part of the deal. And then sort of on top of that, I felt like, oh yeah, back in 1992, they should have done it back then anyway. So
weren't a libertarian really at that point either.
I wasn't exactly a libertarian at that point either. But and I guess the last thing was, is that some, people, it was kind of going around as a rumor, we'd have lower gas prices.
Well, that's always a reason to kill. I think lower prices at the tank. No, I'm not trying to be a jerk.
I know these reasons stink now.
It's part of it is. I mean, because this is just because people don't want to pay attention and don't want to take the slightest bit of time to apply critical thinking to how the world works. But many people tied it to, didn't those Iraqis do 9/11? I mean, that is, but you know what, though? If you look back, that's all the propaganda. And it was not just, right, we love to blame right-wing radio. But at the time, all the so-called, moderate liberals and the members of the Democratic Party, have always been very, just less aggressive about it, but have always been very, very supportive of these wars. So it's not as if you had, alternatives to the propaganda necessarily, unless you read obscure leftist magazines or anarchists or libertarian or spoke to libertarians regularly. So it's very easy to have believed the nonsense. And after all, I mean, we're meant to think of people like George Bush as being very special people. Like there's something special. There's an aura about him.
He's the president.
Yes. My God, how could he must know things that we don't. I mean, not that he's BSing you.
They'll say things like, that's above my pay grade. People will literally say stuff like that.
I've heard he poops gold. Sorry, that totally killed the conversation. Wasn't my intention. So, yeah, I mean, old Mark, I mean, this was a decade ago, Mark, that you thought those things. There's more coming up here. Angela, you're sticking with us for one more segment, right?
Yes.
All right, great. And if you got a question, by the way, for Angela Keaton, she's here with us from antiwar.com. And we've got time for you, 855-450-FREE. And, of course, you can bring up anything you want. We'll start the regular show in hour number two. So one more segment with Angela, 855-450-FREE. She knows stuff about this anti-war world, and she can answer your questions. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your products and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
If you are successful at what you do, whether you're a doctor, a lawyer, a business owner, or you have a great career, you understand the concept of protecting yourself. Well, are you protecting yourself, your family, and your assets with quality term life insurance? Consider these possible rates. A man age 45, non-tobacco user, could obtain $1 million of coverage for as little as $75 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 10 years. We specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. A man age 50, non-tobacco user, may be able to obtain $500,000 of coverage for as little as $115 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 20 years. We have great rates for smokers, too. Call the Term Lifeline now. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You dial toll free. Bring up whatever you want. 855-450-FREE. We'll get into the whatever you want status of the show here coming up in hour number two. We're going to continue the discussion with Angela Keaton from antiwar.com right now. Of course, if you've got a call, if you've got a question for Angela, she's here. She'll be happy to field that. And that's what we're going to jump right into here. Angela, you still with us? Yes?
I'm still with you.
Excellent.
But I just want to say that, you know, I don't always have answers to questions because as funding has gotten tighter over the years. There's lots of reasons for that. I spend more and more time fundraising and finding other revenue than I do spending reading and studying foreign policy every day. And that's the reality of this
job. You still
do
it more than I do. I can tell you that. Let's go to Don. He's in Tallahassee. Don, you're on Free Talk Live listening to WVFT.
Thank you. I do want to speak to this issue that Angel is talking about. And we're kind of in a dilemma, or she is, anyhow. But first of all, I'd like to say, you know, I'm not against war altogether. I am against a president usurping Congress and giving troops to a war for a country that really is not harming us in any way. I mean, we have dictators all over the world. We don't have to go far off our shores to find, you know, dictators and bad guys that are in office. In fact, some of the worst guys are probably in our own government. But
yeah.
Anyway, the point is for you know, I see a design in this. It, somewhat sinister, because if you think about it, Saddam Hussein, bad a guy as he was, first of all, they didn't find any of those things. They actually admitted later on that it was bad intelligence that caused them to act upon that going in there. I think it had more to do with taking out a dictator that was a problem to whatever the rule was. I mean, when you think about it, Al-Qaeda could not get to Iraq. We had the same problem in Egypt, now Libya. We've got, you know, these terrorist groups, Hamas and Al-Qaeda, and do it every week or month. And they're fascinating. I mean, they're all over Iraq now, you know, and so ISIS. And so what I'm saying is, I think it was kind of known that, you know, Saddam Hussein, as bad as it was, he kept the other bad guys, the worst guys, out because he had an iron grip on the country. Now, if you want to talk bad guys, what about China? Why don't we just, you know, free a billion people that we could free from their enslavement if we're really just going to go out and, you know, war?
Don, I want to give Angela a chance to respond to that. Angela, your thoughts on what Don had to say about Iraq? You know, was it really that they were just really going after Saddam more so than anything else?
I think Don made many, many excellent points, and I hope he talks to friends and family and others about a lot of his thoughts on this, because it makes perfect sense. I mean, we do have bad guys all over the world. I mean, people are bad actors, and Barack Obama happens to be one, but we don't ask the Venezuelans to come here and do something about it. Nor should we. It should be our problem. I mean, it really should be our problem. And I guess I'm much more of an old right winger in the sense that, you know, mind your own business. Stay the hell out of other people's problems in both personal life and in foreign policy. It works.
Well, and also to Don's last point, I mean, aren't things getting better in China? It looks to me like over the last couple decades, you know, production has ramped up over there. There's more freedom now, it seems like, to do business when, you know, from the outside of, you know, not having to be state run, for instance. I mean, China's not doing so bad, right? I mean, all things considered.
You know, I'm not an expert on – I'm sorry.
No, go ahead. I was just going to say, you know, when you did a segment on, you know, the most and least free countries in the world, and USA was somewhere down, you know, 28, 38, something like that, there's other ways to measure freedom. And I think, like, the freedom to own a gun, you know, you don't have that right in China to own a gun. Why? Because the government wants to have monopoly on the force that, you know, and also – you can't leave that country. I mean, you know, if you don't like America, you can pass up and leave.
Oh, that's not necessarily true. I mean, if you don't,
yeah, there's a big exit tax, and you've got to fill out their paperwork and pay their forms.
Yeah, I mean, you got to get master's permission to leave this plantation. Don, thanks for the call. Good thoughts tonight. I do appreciate hearing from you.
You could own an AK-47 in Saddam Hussein's. You know, people had them all over the place in Iraq.
So, Angela, yeah, your thoughts on China.
Oh, I'm not an expert on internal policy, but in terms of foreign policy, there's sometimes tensions with Japan, but honestly, they're not nearly as aggressive as we are, and they don't seem to be as hell-bent on empire building. That doesn't mean they're
involved. By we, you don't mean you and I, and we're not aggressive.
You and me. Well, yeah, you and me are the ones who in many ways are taxed and secretly taxed for the bill for these insane adventures. But I love some of the points that Don made, particularly about the matter of Saddam Hussein. Now, this is not an ideal situation to have a strong man, but he definitely made sure that, you know, religious minorities were protected. It was actually it was a secular Muslim country, the way U.S. is a secular Protestant country in a lot of ways. And women certainly had many more rights than in many of countries in that part of the world. So, I mean, yes, of course, you know, living under any emperor or any leader is horrible, or having anyone who has more control over your life than you do is horrible. But, you know, as far as horrible people go, he was, you know, I mean, there, you know, it was not an absolute living hell in Iraq, and he was holding, mm-hmm. you know, sort of holding things together. So not a great argument for having a leader, but certainly a great argument for you know, the U.S. military not to go in and seize power. So I absolutely agree with that. And I love Don's points about how to measure freedom. I mean, gun ownership, a very important one.
Let's talk to Daniel. He's in South Carolina listening to WRNN. Hello, Daniel. You're on with Angela.
How you doing?
You're on with Angela. Great. Go ahead.
Yes, sir. I don't know. It just sounds like y'all whining an awful lot about military going in over there. Okay. I mean, they had certain intelligence that told them that there was things over there that could harm the U.S. They acted upon it. If later they found out that was incorrect intelligence, that's fine, and they can back off from it. But the fact is that you don't have time to sit around and wait and placate everybody when you get certain things, when you find out certain things. You either act upon it or you don't. And if you don't and something would have happened, then you always be sitting here talking junk about the government, about, oh, they should have went in there and done something.
Yeah, you'll never hear us say the government should have done something.
That's certainly true. But Angela, are you just whining?
Am I just whining? Well, you know what? I'm kind of a cranky, and as older adults, I'm kind of right-wingy, and I don't like welfare of any kind. And I certainly, you know, the U.S. military, the whole Pentagon, is one big damn welfare program. People taking my taxes. I work more than one job, and I'm tired of people getting a ride, whether it's, you know, through U.S. military, you know, basic training, or whether it's through food stamps. I think people should earn their own damn way in the world, and the military is like they're supposed to do something. What are they supposed to do? It sounds like a make-a-work job problem to me. Iraq was never a threat to the U.S. It was none of our business. We never should have been over there, and I certainly don't want anyone spending my money so other people can go do something with themselves. Go do something on your own damn time. Find a job.
Okay, so you're saying that the military is welfare.
Well, you better believe it. It's the largest welfare program.
Yeah, a lot of people call it Republican welfare.
I was in it for 17 years in three different deployments. And I worked for a living. I worked for every dime I got.
Well, you did that on my money, though. You didn't make any wealth. What did you create? Did you make a spoon? Did you make a widget? What do you think?
What do you think? They're going to dissolve the military? Everybody's going to come over and hold your hand and sing Kumbaya?
I don't want any of those hippies singing Kumbaya with me, and I want my tax money back, damn it.
I think it was a good question, Angela. He didn't really answer it. What wealth did you create when you were in the military?
Well, I supported the local economy.
Well, that's a customer. It's not a wealth creator.
Well, I mean, no, I didn't create any wealth.
Right.
But what wealth are you creating sitting on the phone?
Yeah, we produce a product. We do advertising, you know, those kind of things.
Entertainment. Thanks for the call, Daniel. I appreciate it. And hopefully a little bit of enlightenment at the same time.
You know, I think this is a tough situation because, you know, people in the military are paid to follow orders. And Daniel followed orders like he was supposed to. He did what he was paid to do. But at the same time, what I really have a problem with is the orders, right? Like, I don't think that the United States has been made materially more safe in the last six decades by foreign policy. I really can't. You know, I'd love somebody to call in and tell me exactly how that happened, but it seems like, you know, things like the Korean War and Vietnam and these sorts of things did not make the United States materially safer. I'm talking about the land mass, not the interests, because I don't know what the interests are. The interests aren't my interests. So
that's exactly it.
Right. The interests are the interests of moneyed people and politicians that really have nothing to do with me. If there's going to be a standing military, and the founding fathers had a problem with this, many of them had a problem with the standing military. If there's going to be one, it probably should stay inside the U.S. borders.
Hey, Angela, it's been great having you on again here on Free Talk Live. And I know you're constantly out there promoting LRN.FM, but when you get a chance, make sure you promote our African fundraiser. We're trying to get our satellite signal back on in a place where it's really needed the most. And folks can help out with that at africa.lrn.fm. And check out more of Angela at antiwar.com. Thanks, Angela.
Thank you.
More coming up.
Well, I did it. I finally left the empire behind. And now that I'm safely settled in Chile, I'm gathering with others like me to build a new community called Fort Go.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Have yourself a good night. And
you too.
As always, let us know if we can be of assistance.
Oh, no. You're great. Thanks a lot, guys.
All right.
Bye.
See you.
Online at fortgault.com. That's fortgault.com.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Every day you make investment decisions. When you do business with and hold U.S. dollars,
You make an investment in the soundness of the moral philosophy and the potential longevity of the United States hegemony. People who claim a monopoly on violence around the world. If this is the investment that you want to make, please keep listening to LRN.FM. If not, stop using their currency. Use bitcoins. Get educated. We use coins.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, March 21st, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.75 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,183 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $262. Antiwar.com reports 12 years ago, the U.S. military invaded Iraq, falsely claiming an Iraqi weapons of mass destruction program and 9/11 as a pretext. Like most American wars, it was supposed to be a cakewalk, a quick regime change, and being greeted as liberators. Like most American wars, it did not turn out that way. Joint Chiefs of Staff Chairman General Martin Dempsey took part in the 1991 Iraq War and the 2003 Iraq War, and yesterday marveled at the sense of deja vu he is experiencing as the U.S. builds up for another protracted war in Iraq. General Dempsey insisted he did not expect the U.S. military to be active in Iraq by now, something most officials can probably relate to. The easy wars have added up to a single protracted disaster. Dempsey and other Pentagon officials are trying to play up lessons learned in the past failures, but they again warn that the whole thing hinges on some sort of unity between Iraq's Shiite and Sunni populations, something the U.S. has proven time and again to be unable to pull off. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. UPI reports the Federal Reserve paid the U.S. Treasury a record $96.9 billion of its profits in 2014, according to documents released by the central bank on Friday. The jump in its annual remittances to the Treasury was due in part to interest income earned on bonds the Fed purchased in recent years in an effort to help rebound the U.S. economy. The Fed paid the Treasury $79.6 billion in 2013. The number is expected to go down in the coming years as the Federal Reserve lets its bond program gradually shrink and looks to increase interest rates. Buoyed by the strengthening economy, the central bank announced an end to the bond buying program in October. The Fed's total assets at the end of 2014 were $4.5 trillion, up $0.5 trillion from the previous year. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports an Ohio man freed last year after spending 39 years in jail for a murder he did not commit will receive more than $1 million from the state for his wrongful imprisonment. An Ohio Court of Claims judge on Thursday ordered that just over $1 million be paid to Ricky Jackson, the longest-held U.S. prisoner to be cleared of a crime. Jackson told the Cleveland Plains Dealer, which said he learned of the payment from a journalist, "Wow, wow, that's fantastic, man. I don't even know what to say. This is going going to mean so much. Jackson was convicted along with Wiley Bridgman and Bridgman's brother, Kwame Ajemu, for the 1975 murder of Harold Franks, a money order salesman in the Cleveland area, after a 12-year-old boy testified he saw the attack. The boy, Eddie Vernon, recanted his testimony years later and told authorities he never actually witnessed the crime. There was no other evidence linking Jackson to the killing. Other witnesses confirmed that the then-teenage Jackson was on a school bus at the time of the killing. He had originally been sentenced to death but escaped because of a paperwork error. Bridgman was freed soon after the charges were dismissed last November. Although Bridgman was first freed in 2002, he was imprisoned again for a probation violation. A Cleveland judge in December dropped all charges against Ajemu, who spent 27 years in jail before having his death sentence commuted and being freed in 2003. The 39 years Jackson spent in jail was the longest time a prisoner has been held before being exonerated. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Good morning. Later this afternoon, I will be engaging in an extramarital affair. Of course, I will wish that I had never made the horrible mistake I'm about to spend several hours making, but sadly, I'm currently too blinded by greed and lust to care about or consider the consequences of my actions. The liaison I will be taking part in shortly with two poor deaf teenage runaways is in direct opposition to the values you elected me to uphold. I also wish to apologize to my wife, Linda, to my two beautiful children, Allison and Christopher. It hurts me more than you will ever know that this scandal will impact your life so terribly. I can only pray that the revelations you will soon hear concerning my fetishes, physical flexibility, and penis will not scar you to the point of dementia. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to get to the hotel immediately, so I will not be taking questions. Thank you.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, we're launching into the second hour here of the live Saturday edition. We've got plenty of time for you. Because we do 3 hours every single night, 7 nights a week. You can join us here on the phones at 855-450-FREE. You can join us on Skype, and you'll sound great most of the time. Skype username is lrn.fm. Just send a contact request. It will be approved. Mark, I know you've got something to say. We've got some calls. Do you want to throw out some red meat, and then we'll see what you have to say and then jump into the phone calls?
Yeah, real quick, I just, Daniel called in there and, basically didn't like our position, our anti-war position.
And he was in the military.
And, you could expect that from somebody who spent their life there and went on 3 deployments and that sort of thing. But I think he was put in an unfair position. As a military man, it's not his job to be an economist and understand what production means. People in the military do produce something. They just produce it inefficiently. Governments, tend to produce things inefficiently. So he produced protection services. However, those protection services have been largely mismanaged over the course of 6 decades.
Yeah, I don't feel protected by them.
Right. So the military provides protection services, though protection services are meted out by liars and thieves in Washington, D.C.
I mean, if your protection service results in greater danger, you're not doing a good job.
Well, I don't know that you're supposed to know, right? Like, you sign up, you're told your whole life, this is a great job and everything. You sign up for it, and you do what you're told because that's what you're told to do. And then at some point or another, you may or may not come to the conclusion that, it might be U.S. foreign policy that's making the United States less safe.
That's definitely the conclusion I've come to.
That's the conclusion I've come to, too.
855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. Tony's in New Jersey. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Tony.
Yeah, let me put this in a different context, but I think we're on the same page. There's a big difference between a qualitative judgment and a quantitative judgment. And I think our culture today is now becoming a culture where we don't make qualitative judgments. We put everything into categories of numbers. So people are not persons. You could call a person, you get a feeling you're dealing with someone who has feelings. But when you call a person collateral damage, when we've developed a toy mentality. And I don't know how this culture is going to get out of the novelty of war is an actual death wish toy. It's a game. They even call it a game. The video games, we got young kids playing video games, enjoying killing people. We are becoming a culture that is in love with the illusion of death. The problem is, when people really die, we have no more feelings for that because we've been conditioned of this quantitative way of looking at life.
Well, we have as a general public, but the soldiers, they feel it. There are more soldiers dying from
suicide
by a long stretch than ever died in combat. I mean, the death toll of the war continues to rack up, and it racks up amongst soldiers that never get hurt, soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marines that never get hurt. You know, their pain is something that doesn't get broadcast on the news. To them, that death is very, very real. They see it. They see it in their minds every day.
Yeah, but the culture doesn't allow the discussion, like you said. There's no discussion that you take any person who's homeless. Everyone always goes to the quantitative judgment. Why don't they get a job? Because once you put people in categories of numbers, it's a form of necrophilia. You could talk about a deviant curve in the bell curve. Well, how many people commit suicide? And you put it in those numbers, they go, well, that's like only 0.15%. You're talking about people, but the language allows you to reduce everything to numbers. And once you get that kind of a neurosis, you can't feel for people. And I even heard something on the radio that made me sick. A little dog snapped, and it almost bit somebody, but it didn't. And the person who's supposed to love animals said, well, you have to put the dog to sleep. That's a known fact. When a dog snaps, so nobody knows what the natural habitat is. An emotionally sound person would say, you know what? You're right. We can't keep the dog around kids. But I'm not going to put the dog to sleep. I know people who could handle a snapping dog. And it might even be fun because that person is capable of handling that situation. But once you put everybody in the same category, there are no special roses. There are no special girlfriends. Everybody is just another cloud, another tree. And when you live like that, you know who lived like that? One of those famous cases in history. Leopold and Loeb, they killed a 9-year-old kid for an experiment. When they had IQs of 175 each, when they finally graduated, they realized what they did was wrong, but it took years and years to catch up. So how are you going to create a sane society when we have military schools that teach you 365 days out of the year how to kill as many people as you can and put them into numbers.
Thank you, Tony, for your call tonight. I appreciate it. I think he's always got some thoughtful things to say there. And I would also qualify all of the government schools as military schools. I mean, I realize they're not technically military academies, but ultimately they're very friendly toward the military. They encourage young people to join the military. They allow the military to operate on campus.
You don't see McDonald's there generally. I mean, you know, that's one of the, I don't know.
There was actually, they actually had Pizza Hut, I think, at the school. They sold Pizza Hut pizza.
They're not recruiting though.
No, right.
Just because they're, you know, the military isn't shooting kids either.
Right. They let the military in to recruit. They let the military in to do the ROTC, I think it's called, ROTC. It's sort of this pre-training program, pre-brainwashing, more so than the average classroom would have military, you know, pro-military propaganda. The school's curriculum, of course, is very pro-government, pro-military. So I think that all government schools are military schools in a way.
I would agree with you largely. The military has sort of special circumstance too. They're looking for young, able-bodied people as opposed to more private market businesses. They're much more likely to be able to handle people throughout their lifespans, whereas the military pretty much wants you from 18 on up to 30.
Well, plus you're freshly getting out of the government indoctrination center, so you're freshly indoctrinated with whatever sort of propaganda they want to shove into your head about how great the military is. So that's a good time to recruit when people don't know any better and when they're all hyped up on testosterone at a young age.
Also don't have the situation where you're looking for people who have roots down. I mean, the military doesn't want you to have roots down. They want to be able to send you around the world. And so young people, coming out of school, they aren't necessarily going this place or that. When I got out of school, I just really didn't know what I was going to do. I didn't, college didn't seem like I wasn't dying to go for another four more years of school. I didn't really have anything I wanted to do in particular.
Jim's in Humboldt, California, listening to KGOE. Hey, Jim. Jim?
Yeah, hello. I just want to say I'm a Vietnam era vet. When we were in basic training and rifle training, we were taught to kill the sick, the lame, and the lazy. And I thought, well, who do they threaten? And then I thought about it. Well, they threaten exploiters. You can't make any money on them. And so listening to you two guys pontificate all the time, I know neither one has been in the service. I know you're well-intentioned, But I think you need to look around. You're living in the mouth of a dragon, and you keep talking about how we can turn into a butterfly. Ain't gonna
what
happen
does
now.
That mean? Can you translate
what does that mean?
Yeah, what do you mean by that?
Well, how many military bases does America have in the world?
Between 600 and 1,000, depending on how you count them.
Right. Now, why we have 1,000? You're right. Between 1,000, almost 1,000 military bases around the world. All right. So
hold that thought, Jim. I want to give you a chance to complete what you're saying, so we're gonna have to hang on to you.
70-pound Royal Standard Poodle. Her name is Zelia. And 3 years ago, Zelia's ears were a mess. She would have sticky, gooey, smelly discharge in her ears. We took Zelia to the vet 7 times of $150 every time. The vet offered no success at all. My wife and I are driving, and we hear some people on the radio saying D-I-N-O-V-I-T-E.
859-428-1000. The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
6 days after I started feeding her Dinovite, my dog's ear problems were cured. My dog no longer yelps. She can be petted without pain, and it's because Dinovite made our dog healthy again.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website, fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper, FPP News, at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free to join us here on the live Saturday edition, 855-450-FREE. Doesn't have to be, you don't have to talk about war. That's what we talked about with antiwar.com's Angela Keaton in the first hour. You can bring up anything that you want. And of course, we've got stuff to talk about here tonight as well, including Scientology is back in the news with a new documentary coming out on HBO that will be, oh, let's just say, a little critical of the bizarre religion. But we'll get back into your phone calls in a moment.
FortGult.com. What they're doing in southern Chile is creating a sort of little liberty enclave. The idea is they're going to build this, call it somewhere between like a resort and a condominium complex. There's going to be a maker space there, some really cool amenities like a restaurant, a bunch of places to relax and socialize. And they're going to have really small units, so basically condominium units, really small ones that you can own, and then potentially rent out to people who are coming to stay and that sort of thing. So they're going to have, sort of a hotel aspect to it too. It's really cool, and you should go check it out for yourself. They've got a fantastic presentation at FortGult.com. Gult is as in John Galt, G-A-L-T, FortGult.com. Go check them out. There's only 100 units available, so it could go quickly. And I'd like to point out, summer in Chile is winter in the U.S. So FortGalt.com.
All right, we got Jim with us in Humboldt, California, listening to KGOE. Jim, I wanted to make sure you had a chance to get your thoughts out, and we are nailed to the clock here. So what were you trying to say before the break there?
Well, I've already said that. Just let me say this. If you people really are sincere about what you're doing, take your radio show to one of these veterans' hospitals and let these people tell their story instead of peddling all your crap. You're peddling, creating bitcoins and all that stuff.
Excuse me, what crap are you saying that we're peddling?
What crap are you peddling?
Yeah.
You're taking up, you're selling advertisers. You're selling ears to advertisers. That's your job. That's what you really are about.
Ultimately, right? Radio's about advertising. We have to have that in order to make a living,
rationalize it any way you want. I'm just trying to tell you what you're really doing. And you guys talk so much in between calls. I don't know if you don't get enough calls or what. What I'm saying is don't fancy that you're doing anything other than what you really are doing. And your agenda is what? Selling ears to advertisers.
I don't think we've ever pretended anything besides that. Oh, he hung up.
Well, as though it's bad to run a commercial radio program, I would say that this is decidedly the least radio program that does that the least. The fact
what do
is,
you mean?
Free Talk Live isn't about that. Free Talk Live is about is about the liberty movement, is about the ideas of freedom. If you
if we don't have advertisers, I mean, we're not going to be on the air.
Yeah, I agree with you on that, Ian. But you're saying that as a person who will turn down advertisers if they don't fit philosophically with Free Talk Live. If you don't think that they're going to work with
if the military came in here and wanted to advertise, I'd have a problem with that.
Right, because you are philosophically driven. You are not monetarily driven. I can tell you that the That's rest true. Of the programs out there are not. They will sell the right-wing talk radio programs that across this country took ad dollars from Barack Obama during 2008 and 2012. That's because they want that money.
Yeah. Well, we also take some contributions directly from our listeners. So we've got the Free Talk Live AMP program.
Pretty much any radio program does that, though.
Well, but Mark, that's not true, because most radio programs take they have subscriptions. A lot of them have subscriptions for their website, but that just gets you into a members area, and then the money for the subscriptions goes to pay all the people who administer the website, right? Like, there's Rush Limbaugh, for instance, is not administering his Rush 24/7. Rush isn't there thanking each listener or whatever who sends him an email and signs up for the AMP program. He's not there providing customer service. They have people who do that, right? On Free Talk Live, the money from the AMP program, whatever it is that we're left with after PayPal or the credit card companies take their 3%, 97 or so percent of the money from the AMP program goes into Free Talk Live, in that we're using it to advertise, market, and promote Free Talk Live. I don't know if there are other nationally syndicated radio shows who are doing anything like that.
Not the same way, but they have a little Mouseketeer club like we do.
Yeah, but don't forget, you get all the content from freetalklive.com for free. So you can go to freetalklive.com right now without being in the AMP program, and you can download years worth of the program. I mean, you can download as many episodes as you could humanly listen to at this point. There's so much free content there at freetalklive.com.
Right. Well, here's what I think. I think that the gentleman, he's probably very upset. And he's probably upset because he's listening on a lefty station, right? Because Free Talk Live's on—
Yeah, that's true. KGOE is a progressive talker.
Free Talk Live is on lefty and righty stations. He's on a lefty station, and we don't agree with him, right? Like, he's not going to— we're not lefties, right? We might be bringing the anti-war message out, but we're not lefties.
But every one of those hosts on KGOE is also selling advertising as well. I mean, Tom Hartman,
but it's okay,
Stephanie Miller.
If they believe similarly to the listener, right? The only listeners that are going to have problems is the ones that disagree. Well, Free Talk Live boldly goes on radio stations where the vast majority of people disagree with us. And that's fine. You can disagree. We open up the phone lines at 855-450-FREE for you to call in and make cogent points.
I am
going to, however, reject the notion that Free Talk Live does what it does for the money. Because you would continue doing this if I left took the advertisers with me.
I would.
It is BS from start to finish. If the gentleman believes that, he's full of crap.
Yeah.
Now, he probably believes it. I shouldn't say full of crap. He is mistaken. And that's
it. Yeah, he's wrong about that. You're right. I mean, this is— – and Mark, they say in the business that you're not supposed to do radio from an ideologically sort of driven standpoint. And I think that's generally probably a true statement. But we're doing something that's a little bit different here with Free Talk Live, because our ideology is not represented in talk radio. I mean, I guess, if every host on radio was a principled libertarian, then, yeah, I mean, we wouldn't really have as much of whatever clout we have, because it would have been harder for us to get into the business.
We would have never gone anywhere.
Yeah, and differentiate ourselves from the rest of the
Free
pack.
Talk Live is ranked the 42nd most important radio program in America, because— not because of its size,
Talkers Magazine.
Right, by Talkers Magazine. We're on 150 something stations across the country. By no means are we the largest show in America.
I wouldn't even say we're second tier.
It's not because of our listener quantity, because we're not on the biggest radio stations in America either. It's because of the way we went about creating our business, and it's about the position that we take on issues. Our position is unique.
We didn't even have an advertiser for like the first, 4 years of the show, pretty much?
Yeah, pretty much. We did it as a hobby.
06.
We did it as a hobby at that point.
Yeah.
But
a full-time hobby.
It's unusual the way that we go about doing these things. And if, you can't handle hearing a message that is different than what you want to hear, you're not really ready for talk radio. You're not ready for adulthood, and you're not ready for conversation.
Let's talk to Phil. He's in Charleston, South Carolina. Phil, you're on Free Talk Live.
Gentlemen, it's great to get on the air with you.
Thanks, man. Go ahead.
I've listened to the show for a couple of years, and I really do generally enjoy most of the time.
Excellent.
But I got to take you to task a little bit.
Please.
With more so your guest, Andrea, I think what her name was.
Angela.
But you guys kind of piled on. I think that the you got awful condescending and took out of it the military fellow a little bit more than I think he deserved.
Yeah, me too. I came back and said that. Didn't you hear that at the top of the hour?
I may have caught. I'm not sure. I was driving and the sound hasn't been so great.
I didn't hear you say that, Mark, but I wasn't paying attention either.
Well, I wasn't as...
Phil, hang on. I want to give you a chance to say what you got to say. Stand by. We'll bring you back here in a moment. Phil in Charleston, your call's welcome as well. 855-450-FREE. You can take control here on Free Talk Live's Live Saturday Show.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your product and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. you can dial in toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And now, more shameless information about products and services that could help your life be better. That's what we do here on Free Talk Live. It is how we kind of, you know, keep the show going at its maximum capacity. And, you know, most people understand that about talk radio. We had some guy bitching at us earlier in the hour. And I guess he doesn't want to know about ProXPN, which is a way to actually protect yourself online. ProXPN encrypts your internet connection. Why does that matter? Well, because, first of all, your internet service provider is probably logging every website that you visit. Now, you know, they could certainly turn that over to law enforcement, and maybe you don't think you're doing anything wrong, but fact is, a lot of people are breaking the law every day without even realizing it. There's so many felonies out there that you can essentially...
Commit without knowing it.
Right, you can involve yourself in and you have no idea. So better to protect yourself. And also, they might just sell that information and then, you know, market your details to people that you would prefer they not sell that information to. So if you encrypt your data connection, you protect yourself from that. You also protect yourself from unscrupulous people who might be sniffing your Wi-Fi packets, maybe trying to snag your passwords, for instance. So ProXPN can help you there. And with their premium account, which you can get a sweet discount on, I'll tell you about in a moment. You get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access. You can privately torrent, which, by the way, I've looked up private torrenting services online, Mark, and they cost more than ProXPN does, just for private torrent services. And that's one of the things you can do with ProXPN. Plus, you can get past regionally blocked websites. It's a super deal, especially at about $5 a month, just under $5 a month. When you use code FTL50, that gets you 50% off the price of their annual account. Start by going to proxpn.com/FTL and grab their software. It's free. You download that for Windows, Mac, iOS devices, Android devices, and even Linux. Grab their software, get started, and when you're ready to upgrade, use code FTL50 to get a discount off of the annual account. And that locks in for the lifetime of your account, so when, you know, year number two comes up, you're ready to re-up, you get the same great deal with code FTL50 at proxpn.com/FTL. It's all there with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. It's a great discount on privacy that is priceless. proxpn.com/FTL, code FTL50. Back with Phil in Charleston. He wanted to call us out. Go ahead, Phil. Now you got plenty of time.
All right, I appreciate it. I think he was getting after you on the Bitcoin thing a little bit, too. But
oh, I love Bitcoins, and I'm shameless about them. I think that they'll bring they're going to bring more power to people individually, and they're also going to bring more peace to the world because governments can't print money out of thin air and then use that money to drop bombs on innocent people.
Both are noble goals. I absolutely agree with you. Same time, the show has a tendency every now and then to get just a hair idealistic.
Please,
every night
it's an idealistic show.
And the thing is, you have to deal with the world as it is to a certain extent.
No, I don't. I moved to New Hampshire, and the fact is I moved to New Hampshire, and I almost exclusively deal with libertarians in most of my life. So I don't actually have to deal with life by its own standards. It's cool.
I want to hear what Phil's trying to say, Mark.
I just recommend it. I'll keep Phil another segment. I'm just going to respond.
Go ahead, Phil.
That's cool. Dealing with libertarians would be a good thing. The government is clearly way, way, way too big, okay? When you mentioned just a moment ago about how many felonies there are on the books and whatnot. But I think that it would be unrealistic of us to say, oh, okay, we're going to just withdraw all the military from all the foreign bases everywhere in the world and let the few countries that have had them in your countries for all this time just deal with it as of tomorrow night, you know?
Well, it may be unrealistic. It may be unrealistic that the government's certainly not going to do that because this is a huge government program. I mean, it's bigger than the postal service. They're not just going to let that disappear overnight. But is there anything wrong with that idea?
Well, if doing it,
I'm asking Phil, not you, Mark.
Well, what I really believe should happen, I think that we should make a statement to the world at large that we are going to stop being the world's policemen.
Okay.
And we're going to start gradually drawing that back. And you're going to see evidence of the fact that we're drawing it back. But, you know, certainly a lot of these countries depend on us being there to support their local economies. And there are others of those countries that we need to be in, I think, because were it not for our military presence, we might have a whole bunch of people with big, long swords and sabers wanting to chop the heads off of everybody who doesn't want to convert to
So, 2 points to respond to that. One, I'm not concerned with the U.S. military's supporting of local economies by buying alcohol and prostitutes or whatever the hell else it is that they're buying over there. If they've got, you know, a reason to attract people to come visit that country, then they should put that out there and get tourists, which is the legitimate way to support.
Come to Chizikistan.
A local
enjoy
economy.
Enjoy whatever the heck we've got here.
I'm not interested in providing welfare to various different countries around the world, whether it be through the military's presence and soldiers spending money or through foreign aid. I'm not interested in that. If I want to support another country around the world, then I'll go ahead and do that.
Okay, I'd like to respond because Ian's going to say things that that he feels and not think about it at all. The military is intended to be used as a stabilizing force. If the military is directly withdrawn, like, you know, tomorrow, as though that's going to happen, then yes, it will become a destabilizing force, and the military should not be used as a destabilizing force. However, if an edict is issued and it is said over the course of the next 2 years, you better, you know, I don't know, figure out how to control your own country because we're leaving, then, you know, that's a pretty good idea, and I'm willing to go for it. Yes, I think these things need to be done in steps.
I had a second point, but I forgot what it was. Yeah. Go ahead.
It didn't make any sense anyway.
You have a good example of it with our withdrawal from Iraq and what's happened there. You know, we laid out our, and I'm not trying to beat up on Obama with this or anything, but we said we're leaving. We're getting out on such and such a date, pulled out, and the whole thing went to hell in a handbasket. And it didn't have to be that way if we had kind of stepped our way out gradually. But I understand that we have a nasty habit of not stepping out, okay?
Well, I, for one, have never been to Iraq. I'd like to point that out.
Stop it, Ian.
No
one cares whether the man says we or not.
I do care, and I won't stop it.
Fine.
You know what I'm talking about.
He's talking about the U.S. military.
Not me. I'm not in the military, so I wasn't there.
Yeah, I understand.
We know you're not in the military. The fact that the military went in the first place is one of the things that destabilized Iraq. Let's not forget that.
Yes, I think that's an important thing to note.
Is that right? I know. I understand exactly. But the thing is, and I'm going to use we again because, like it or not, we did pay for it. You know, and
no, I
and
haven't paid. I haven't paid taxes in like 10 years, so I've really done my best to not pay for it.
Yeah, but by the way, you can see that Free Talk Live's.
Yes, I'm sure about that.
Pretty ideological. Ian doesn't pay income tax, and neither do I.
Yeah, I still pay gas tax, so there's probably some. I don't know, maybe some of the money from the gas tax is going to.
It makes its way there. I'm sure. Yeah. I'm sure they get their.
All right, fine. You got me.
I think gas tax mostly gets used for the roads.
I don't know, Mark. I really – the federal government, I don't think they're using that money on roads.
As long as we're talking about – look, my first foreign policy goal is to step down and step down the U.S. military's presence around the world. If countries are so unstable that the lack of the presence of U.S. soldiers there in 2 or 3 years results in the uprising of people with scimitars that take over the government, I don't care.
Yeah.
If I just don't care. If they attack the U.S., that's when the military should be employed. But the only reason they attack the U.S. now is because, well, the U.S. military is being used to back up Saudi Arabian kings, dictators in Yemen, Israel, which they don't like in many cases. And Israel can take care of themselves just fine.
So, Phil, it's been a really good call. I just want to ask you, since you mentioned it, do you have any Bitcoin yet?
Oh, God.
Not a bit.
It's not too late.
I recommend it. I think you're going to be kicking yourself in a few years.
Yeah. Hey, thanks for the call. Good thoughts tonight. Do appreciate.
We're all going to be kicking ourselves, but okay.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot.
Good call, man. I appreciate that. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Don't forget, you can Skype into the show. You can actually send a Skype request to us. You have to send a Skype request first. So send a contact request to username lrn.fm. We'll approve it as soon as we notice it come in. And then after that, easy for you to call us on Skype. Hey, speaking about Bitcoin, there's an easy way to get those. We'll tell you about that coming up. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Plus, coming up, Scientology. There's a documentary coming out on HBO at the end of the month that's looking to stir it up. And they are not going to be friendly towards the Scientologists. 855-450-FREE. You can take control here on Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Hey, it's Mark of Free Talk Live, and I want to tell you about a new way to be prepared for emergencies. Not just big emergencies, but little ones too. It's a source of backup power, so small that I can put it in my pocket or the glove box of my car, but it's so powerful that it can actually jumpstart a bus if I need it to. Sounds crazy, but it's not. I'm talking about a breakthrough in portable power technology called the Pocket Power Plus. If you get stranded in an airport, in your car, or you just want to go off the grid for a while, the Pocket Power Plus becomes your own personal mini power plant. Run pretty much any kind of electronic device for hours, even days if you need to. The Pocket Power Plus can also deliver an enormous supply of on-demand power that can jumpstart almost any vehicle, even in the coldest winter days. Comes with free jumper cables and an accessory pack. Best part, my listeners can now get Pocket Power Plus for half price by going to PocketPowerPlus9.com. That's PocketPowerPlus9.com. Use coupon code FTL to save even more. Go to PocketPowerPlus9.com, PocketPowerPlus9.com, coupon code FTL.
So who else will you meet at the Get Prepared Expo? For starters, from Republic Broadcasting, John Moore and John Stadtmiller. From GCN, Aaron and Brad Dakins, Joyce Riley, and me, Vincent Finelli. Joining us are the instructors whom you've learned to trust. Surgeon of the Year, Dr. Norman Shuley. Engineer, Matt Stein. The real Fox Mulder of the X-Files, Dr. Richard Allen Miller. Author and analyst, Captain John Reagan. Your counterterrorist from Central America, Mike Ma. Dental center owner and my dentist, Dr. Howard Shane. Radiation instructor, Craig Douglas. Author and survivalist, Rich Sheban. Author, Judy Dollarheit. Cancer center owner from Mexico, Dr. Patrick Vickers. Bug out expert and pilot, Captain Bill Sermo. Beekeeper, Jeff Maddox. Seedsman, Mike Knox. Author, Gayla Pruitt. Author, Harry Cooper. Food expert, Joe Acapinti. And Bill Whaley, the junk man. March 27, 28, and 29. GetPreparedExpo.com, the largest preparedness and survival expo in the USA.
Free Talk Live's recent Bitcoin sale was a big success, so we decided to extend the 50% discount through April 17th.
Free Talk Live was the first ad venue in the world to accept Bitcoins for ads. We love the concept of a value-based digital currency that allows people to actually control their own money.
We introduced Roger Ver,
Bitcoin Jesus,
to Bitcoins, and here's what he said.
Free Talk Live is the premier voice for the peace and liberty Bitcoin will bring to the world. By broadcasting this message since 2011, Free Talk Live has been instrumental in creating the widespread adoption that we have today.
If you need some advertising for your business, website, or organization, and you want to save half off, send me an email right now. Mark@freetalklive.com.
This is your chance to save 50% on national radio and podcast ads. Just pay with Bitcoin. Email mark@freetalklive.com. That's mark@freetalklive.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
I love my Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Help get LRN.fm into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You dial toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The live Saturday edition continues on here. It's Ian with you.
And Mark.
And I did tell you how to get, we're going to tell you how to get Bitcoin. Well, you can also get Litecoin or Dogecoin if you're interested in those things. But Bitcoin, of course, is the big attraction to me. ExpressCoin.com has them, and they'll sell them to you. In fact, you can buy a fraction of a Bitcoin. In fact, you can buy as little as $40 worth or less than that. If you buy up to $40 worth of Bitcoin at ExpressCoin.com and use code FTL, there's no transfer fee. No exchange fee whatsoever when you use code FTL at ExpressCoin.com. And you can trust ExpressCoin. They are fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive.
I've done a lot of business with them.
Yep, and they're a licensed money services business. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, or wire transfer. Now, if you do more than $40 worth, the transfer fee, I think, is like 3% the last time I looked, which is probably the best I've seen in the business out there. So go to ExpressCoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, they can help you out. Plus, they've got an app for your smartphone at ExpressCoin.com. Don't forget to use coupon code FTL to get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee whatsoever. If you've been waiting, if you've been thinking about getting Bitcoin, you know, there's no better time than right now, because you don't know what's going to happen with the price of Bitcoin tomorrow. And I like the Johnny Ray approach of buying like 10% or 5% of your weekly paycheck, just going and buying some Bitcoin, just sort of this habit that you can get yourself into. And ExpressCoin can help you do that. So
make it real easy.
Yep, ExpressCoin.com. Let's go right back to your calls and thoughts. We've got Tater on the line in Ohio River, Indiana. Hello, Tater.
How you doing?
Welcome. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Oh, cool, man. I was wondering if I was going to make it.
Here you are.
I was wondering, actually, you know, your caller a couple calls back was whining about the commercials, man, you got to pay the bills. But my call was about with Obama and the banks and their ability to more or less walk in the bank and take all your assets and put them into their pocket. Myself, I have my tangible assets in my hand and other tradable odds and ends. I live out in the middle of nowhere in an old cabin about 210 years old. So, but
yeah, I agree. I don't trust the banks to store. You really shouldn't trust the bank to store anything you can't afford to lose at any moment. When, you know, if the IRS or the FBI or whoever wants to come in there and get access to your safe deposit box or your account, the bank's just going to let them in and they'll take whatever they want.
Right. Yeah, I'm fortunate to live in a very rural area, and I'm actually up a creek about a quarter of a mile off the Ohio River. I see some pretty wild boats go up and down the river, barges, covered barges, anything from coal to United States government.
What was the point of your call tonight, Tater, just to share concerns about the banking system?
Yeah. I'm just wondering how much actually that the government can walk in and take from us, and how concerned people should be about keeping their money in the bank or investing it and things that actually, because a dollar bill, I don't think is going to stand, you know, for health. You know,
no, I mean, it's already, the dollar's already lost something like 96 or something percent of its value since the gold backing was taken away from it. Tater, I share your concerns and thank you for the call tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I feel
the
like
the government that can give you anything is the government that can take anything from you.
Yeah, and they'll likely, if they're going to take something, they're going to take it all. I mean, if they're going to go into your bank account, they're not going to leave you with a penny.
Yeah, they don't leave you anything.
So, you know, that's why, obviously, we've got to have bank accounts to do business. But at the same time, I know better than to leave. You know, you don't want to put your life savings in a bank account, because whether it's the government who does something with it, or even if the bank freezes the account for some reason, if you've got all your eggs in one basket, so to speak, you're asking for trouble. I mean,
ask business people that use PayPal.
Yeah, there's been a lot of problems with people having PayPal. I'm grateful that we've actually not had those issues with our PayPal account, because we do take PayPal over on our AMP program at amp.freetalklive.com. But at the same time, you know, if they were to put the if they were to freeze the PayPal account, that would be a pretty big dent in the AMP program. But luckily, we also take credit cards, so that's another way that we would still be receiving some funding. But man, if the government wants to go after you, they certainly can. None of these financial institutions are going to stand in their way and say, "Whoa, do you have a warrant?" You know, or anything like that. I mean, if they just walk in and say they want to say they're from the office or department of such and such, and they need access, there's a good chance they're going to let them in. Especially if it's law enforcement. So 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Chris in Wisconsin, listening to the Mike 92.1. Hey, Chris.
Hi. Yeah, I called about the soldier that you were talking to. I got a little bit upset when I heard the way you were speaking to him. But I wanted to mention something that while I was sitting here waiting, I realized that you say in kind of your tagline when you open up about how if you're not ready to hear another opinion, you're not ready for talk radio. And then you said that you moved to New Hampshire so that you could be around all these people that are just like yourself. So I don't think you're really giving yourself the freedom that you think you are, because you're surrounding yourself just with people that think just like yourself. So you don't learn much that way. I think it's very bad to divide our country into all of these little
silos. It's not our country. It's run by a bunch of liars and thieves. It's not your country.
What has happened is our government has gotten corrupted. It is very corrupted by corporations, multinational corporations right now, and they come from the American Legislative
Council. When did that happen?
Down in Washington, D.C.
When was the government not corrupted?
It started happening in the late 90s.
Ridiculous.
Where ALEC came in. But actually, even
that's
more
ridiculous.
So,
the government
right
has been owned by corporations from the beginning.
Really undone. Look, I don't know what you know about history, but you might want to look at it, because the way things are going right now is really bad.
Agreed. And
really
there's nothing you're
going
to do about it. There's nothing I'm going to do about it.
I mean, that's a very defeatist attitude.
I agree with you, Chris.
We're in a country right now where we have a drought in California where they're going to run out of water in a year.
That's okay? California's problem, not mine.
Need. No, it really isn't California's problem. It's everybody's problem, because you know what? Nestle is just pumping water out of that state like you would not believe. I'm getting off the subject I really called to talk to you about, though, but I really think you have to look at the broader sense of what a government is for and who the government is supposed to be run by. And who the government is being run by.
The government has always been run, Chris.
9,000 years of the state, Chris. 9,000 years of the state shows us who a government's supposed to be run by.
9,000 years? Do you know American history? 9,000 years. I don't know where you're coming with that.
Yeah,
but
you're not listening, that's why. So hold on. Let's explain it for you, rather than you just continuing to talk. Mark, what do you mean by that?
Oh, come on. I've been waiting like 20 minutes
yes,
here.
But
I really wanted to talk about how disrespectful you were to this service.
We'd be happy
now
to talk with you about
that. Now you're going around
on
a bunch of different topics.
Yeah, you've covered at least five different topics in 2 minutes.
Topic, but I'll be happy to talk to you about either of them. But I really think that I needed to mention.
Chris, just hold on for one moment here. We're going to give you plenty of time to say things. We understand you've got a lot of opinions. And Mark, what did you mean when you said 9,000 years? Obviously, United States hasn't been around for 9,000 years.
The United States has been around for like 230 or something like that. I haven't done the math on it precisely, but it's something close to that. Right. A democracy or a democratic republic or whatever is just another flavor of an organization that claims a monopoly privilege on the use of violence over a given landmass.
The state.
The state, as it has existed, where people rule other people, the first thing that you can find as sort of evidence of that existed in Jericho, a low tower, and they, call this the first evidence of the state. That's why I use the term 9,000 years. I do, however, believe that you probably had a tribal strongman, and that violence was used to rule over people far earlier than that.
All right, Chris, you're back on. Go ahead.
We have history. You have kings. You have serfs. I mean, it's been the same thing. Call them something different in every age that you can. What we have right now is the best that we've gotten to without having somebody monopolize everything.
Do you think it could be better?
People in harm's way. I agree with you as far as war is concerned. I am anti-war, very anti-war. I don't believe in a standing army. I don't think we need that. I would like to see a Department of Peace. But the government
the best thing to ruin peace would be create a government program for it.
How do you communicate with your neighbors without some form of government? Can you please tell me how you do that?
You talk to them? What do you mean? What does that question even mean?
How?
I'm not proposing that there's not a form of government.
You assume a lot. You assume. You talk about the post office as like it's a bad thing. The post office is...
It is. It has a monopoly.
It pulls this country together. Of course they did, because the government needed to be able to communicate with its citizens.
They needed to be able to arrest the competition. They needed to be able to arrest the competition. You know about that, right?
You know what? There shouldn't have been any competition with the Postal Service.
So you do support arresting Lysander Spooner and putting people who just want to offer a product or service that's better than the post office in jail?
No, I don't support arresting someone who I have no idea who you're talking about.
Right. Take a look at Lysander Spooner,
and you'll
see how...
I do know... I do know that what I am seeing and what I am hearing from you really concerns me. Look, I come from a family that had union members. I had grandparents that came over here. They came over here, and they were indentured servants when they came to this country, all right? And my grandparents got to go, my grandmother got to go to about sixth grade. My grandfather got to go to school till about eighth grade. Okay?
Chris, I want to know more about what concerns you. So hold on. I want to bring her back. I want to know what concerns
Chris. There's people waiting on the line.
It's Free Talk Live. This is, you can take control here.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write "worms" in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 19th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,165, down $10. Silver opened at $15.92, down 7 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $259.50. Today's Bitcoin price is brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest, most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. In the news, officials with the U.S. government have announced they cannot find more than $500 million worth of U.S. military aid given to Yemen. The Pentagon admitted to losing the whereabouts of small arms, ammunition, night vision goggles, patrol boats, vehicles, and other equipment provided by the U.S. Members of Congress have been attending closed-door meetings with military officials in an attempt to hold someone accountable. The Pentagon has suspended all shipments to Yemen. According to a review of federal data, the Obama administration has set a new record for censoring files or blocking access under the U.S. Freedom of Information Act. The Associated Press studied requests to 100 federal agencies during 2014. They found an administration that takes long periods of time to respond to requests and often claimed no records existed or refused to release records until they were challenged in court. The U.S. government spent about $28 million on lawyers' fees to keep records secret. Nearly 40% of all requests were denied. Protesters with the Blockupy Alliance battled with riot police early Wednesday in Frankfurt, Germany, at the opening of a new headquarters for the European Central Bank. An estimated 7,000 people rallied and fought with the police, who threw tear gas and fired a water cannon. Around 550 protesters were detained, 94 police officers were injured by stones, and 7 police cars were set on fire. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from CoinArch, offering innovative trading solutions for Bitcoin. Do more than just buy and sell Bitcoin. Use long and short positions to profit in rising and falling markets and boost your returns through leverage. Visit CoinArch.com and sign up using coupon code MAX and get free brokerage for the first 7 days. Looking to promote your business or cause to tens of thousands of loyal listeners? Well, for a limited time only, the Liberty Beat is offering you the chance to say big while spreading your message. It's simple. Just sign up for 3 months of advertising and get your fourth month free. Don't miss out on this unique opportunity. Just visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise and use coupon code GCN in the Describe Your Company section. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 19th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. On Wednesday, a group of parents of the 43 missing Mexican students appeared in Houston as part of a tour across the United States. Protesters gathered with the families outside of Houston's Mexican consulate, holding signs and chanting. The protest was in solidarity with the families, who have not seen their children since they went missing in September of last year. The parents are planning to travel to New York on April 28th to ask the United Nations to investigate the human rights violations in Mexico. Law enforcement and government officials have been suspected of working with local gangs to murder the students. Researchers in Brazil have published a long-term study in the Lancet Global Health Journal that claims breastfed babies are more likely to turn into well-educated and higher-learning adults. The researchers from Brazil's Federal University of Pelotas followed close to 6,000 babies from birth into their 30s. Around 3,500 of the participants volunteered to be interviewed and take IQ tests. All of the babies who had been breastfed were of higher intelligence, had spent more time in school, and earned higher wages. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support also comes from the Texas Bitcoin Conference. Hear from speakers like Charlie Shrem, Dr. Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, and Catherine Bleich, March 28th and 29th at ACL Live at the Moody Theater. Tickets on sale now at TexasBitcoinConference.com. Use coupon code LibertyBeat for $25 off your ticket. That's coupon code LibertyBeat. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 19th, 2015. Remember to check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Well, our own Rebecca Mera takes us on a tour of the Olympic Village.
We have a full-size bed, lounge area, shower, plenty of space, which is great because I'm constantly having sex in there.
The Village is a temporary home to the world's most physically impressive athletic men and women. It was important to the Olympic Committee to give them a comfortable, state-of-the-art area to f*** each other's brains out while they're not competing.
We have a pool where they can have a sex, a theater where they can have a sex. All these athletes are hot, horny, ready to go. Mm-hmm. They deserve the best.
I was in Vancouver where I got eaten out by this French speed skater. I have to say, these facilities are even better, and I'm going to try to f*** a Japanese guy.
You've spared no expense.
These athletes deserve the best. They sacrifice so much for their countries. They deserve to be able to f*** until their b*** and p*** can't take it anymore.
And these facilities won't go to waste. Once the Olympics are over, they'll be converted to a resort where Russian businessmen can come to f*** their prostitutes.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's Free Talk Live. We're launching into the third hour of the live Saturday edition. We do this thing 7 nights a week live, so you can join us anytime that's convenient for you, as long as it's between 7 and 10 Eastern. 603, excuse me, not 603. That's our local area code. There is a 603 number, but you don't need it right now. You need 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We also have Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Let's jump right back into the calls here. Now, I did hang on to Chris in Wisconsin listening to the Mike 92.1 WXXM. And Chris, the reason I wanted to bring you back, even though Mark was protesting it, was because, you know, you seem to have a problem with some of the, you know, something that you're hearing here on Free Talk Live. But there was a lot that we agreed upon. Like you said that you thought that, you know, the U.S. military doesn't even need to have a standing army, for instance, the military doesn't need to be there. So I agree with you on that.
I would say it's our biggest problem, and it's and we therefore agree on the biggest issue facing America today.
So we're on the same page there. One of the things I disagreed with you about was you claimed that corporations somehow took control in the late 1990s, and you know that's ridiculous. I mean, the U.S. government has been at the beck and call of rich people since the beginning.
Well, actually, it's been incremental. It really has. I mean, when the Glass-Steagall Act was finally killed, that really killed things because you had financial institutions and banks being able to mix up all their money, and that's why we all the shenanigans on Wall Street. So, I mean, you can get into all that. There's a lot of history there. You know, I mean, we had boom-bust before, you know, Roosevelt put the changes in place that prevented that. But really,
but we had boom and bust since Roosevelt, too.
Can I get to the one point that is our difference?
Well, you just made an important point that I think that is really important. You made a really important point. You claimed that somehow booms and busts have stopped.
Okay. Well, yeah, they actually had up until 2008. We really didn't have the boom bust in the same manner that we had the 1929 meltdown. We really didn't. But can I just get to my bigger point?
Because big point. Go now.
We really differ. We differ on your idea of profit. You feel, from what I get from you, profit is everything. Okay. We have water.
What does that even mean?
We have water.
Profit is everything.
We have air.
This show's by the way, run by a church and technically is nonprofit. So I guess you're wrong about that one, Chris. Thanks for the call tonight. Toll free number is 855-450-FREE. There's nothing wrong with profit, but it's certainly not the end all be all. I mean, there's certainly, that's the goal of business is to make a profit in general, because if you don't have profit, then you can't expand. You can't offer new services, for instance. So, and if you also, if you don't have profit, you can't really benefit charity either. Like, if you're not making money at what it is you're doing, then you can't really benefit beyond what you're already doing, I guess is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah. What really is the problem is that really nice car you drive.
I don't drive a nice car. I drive a beat up 2005 cruiser, an old police cruiser.
Well, 2005, that's much newer than the 2002 Ford F-350 that I drive.
Yeah, how
with
many
the
miles
mismatched
are on
bed. This? I got 150,000.
You're doing
really
than
all
me.
About the profit, Ian.
Yeah, no, I don't know about that. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Pretty much everything that we earn from this show is rolled back into the show and the Liberty Movement in general for the purpose of spreading the ideas of freedom. Now, with freedom comes the freedom to make a profit if that's what you'd like to do, and there's nothing inherently wrong or immoral about making a profit. What is wrong and immoral is using
things that are wrong and immoral.
Well, is using force to achieve your goals. If you're profiting by the use of, let's say, having the government force your product or service onto people, that would be an immoral way to make a profit. So there are some wrong ways to make a profit, and then there are right ways to make a profit. The right way to make a profit is to provide a product and service and or service to people in the marketplace on a consensual basis. And if they value it, they'll pay you for it. And that's what most people do with their lives. Let's talk to Josh, and there's nothing wrong with that. Josh is in Indianapolis listening to WIBC. Hello, Josh.
Hello.
Hey, how you're on the air.
Yes, I was just actually calling because of your first caller. I think he just got kind of flustered and just didn't really know where to go with it. So he just started talking about commercial stuff. I'm not really sure what's going on there. But in his first entry point, he said that he was a Vietnam vet. And then you said that, I believe it was, I'm sorry, what's your point? So I was like, what do you mean?
I said,
I'm sorry
to hear. I'm sorry to hear that is what I said, I think.
Right. I was like, okay, well, people join the military for different reasons. I particularly am in the military, but I didn't join because I was, as you say, brainwashed, or I didn't get picked out of a high school. I didn't get picked out of a young. Yes, that's probably where they linger at, because that is what they're looking for, a physical, able-bodied person that has an open mind. There's a lot of good things that do come out of the military. You can't just down it. And
well, first off, did you hear what the other guys, did you hear what the guy said about he was taught in the military to kill the lame and the, the poor people along the side of the road in Vietnam? Did you hear that part?
I did hear that, and yes, there are bad portions in everything. And guess what? There was a bad portion in his particular platoon, his particular squad, his particular ideal that floated around in that, in whatever squad he was in or whoever he was serving with. That is not a military mindset. You can talk to any officer.
I didn't think
that
it was.
Not our goal.
I wouldn't claim that it was, but I did. But there are, there's the stories come out, right? Like the story out of Iraq where the captain said that he would give a week's furlough to the first person who got a bayonet kill. I mean, that's a pretty sick thing to say. And then out of Afghanistan, there were the kill teams where the soldiers just recently got convicted. But I mean, about in 2000,
you have bred someone with that mentality. And, you're trying to be vengeance at the point, but there's a greater purpose. Okay, that I joined for a noble cause, I think.
What was
okay,
that?
I was 27. I was 27 when I went in.
Okay.
Okay, I wanted my girls to have something to be proud of. My father, my grandfather was in, and you know they told me stories. And yes, okay, politicians, the same situations. They all might be, a lot of them might be corrupt, but they go in thinking that they're serving the people.
Oh, I don't believe that for
intention.
A second.
That still isn't okay. Well, that's my intention as I'm there. I joined
as a politician.
That's your intention?
Hold on. Are we talking about politicians? Or are we talking about military men?
I'm trying to put them both in the same type of
they're
category
not.
Because they're both paid by the government.
okay, they're not.
By the government, and they both have ideological items, right? So I joined after Katrina because I joined the National Guard because people lost their homes over there, and I felt really bad about that. I can go over and I can sandbag, and that was the first guys that was getting called up was National Guard guys. And I thought, man, I want to be a part of that. Also, in North Korea, back in that time frame when the Vietnam War and all that was going on, there was different reasons for it, different interdictions. But the reason that some of those guys were there was to stop North Korea from putting their emphasis or forcing the products and goods, like their it was just they were bad people.
Okay. So this is right. Well, I mean, okay,
there's bad people in Washington D.C.
There are
why
lots
you go
of
shoot them.
Lots of bad people running around all over the planet. We can't. I'm not interested in paying for an organization to go get all the bad people. What I'm interested in is keeping. If there's going to be an organization that's going to claim a monopoly on protecting the United States, that organization, and if they're going to call themselves defensive. The Department of Defense, for instance, they should probably be within the borders unless there's for some reason for them to go out. But instead, the U.S. military is all over the place. Okay, well, there's 1,000 military bases, sir. Do you think that there's some kind of good argument for that?
Yeah, actually, I do. I actually went through Israel, and we do have...
I've been to Israel, too, and I'm not interested in paying for those 1,000 bases.
What I'm saying is... You might not be interested in paying for those.
But I got to pay anyway because a guy with a gun who's paid by the government will come and stick it in my face and make me go to jail or pay, right?
It is in our best. Why would a guy with a gun stick in your face to say something about paying whatever to the military?
Okay.
It makes no sense.
So yes, it makes
sure
lots
it does.
Of sense.
Let's lay it down for you.
Go right ahead. You see, there's this form. It's called a W-9. You've got to fill it out. And then you've got to fill out your tax forms. If you don't fill out your tax forms, they'll send you a letter. If you don't respond to the letter, at some point or another, they'll send somebody to your door. If you tell them you're not interested
so
in talking
to them.
I
agree with all the things that the government's doing. Okay, great.
I'm
eventually,
not interested.
Eventually, they're going to put you in a cage, and if you don't want to go to the cage, then they're going to hurt you. And if you don't want them to hurt you and you try to defend yourself with a gun, they are going to shoot you.
Right.
And it might be you.
So do you not want to be a part of it? No, that's posse comitatus. I cannot do that.
Oh, well, they waived the
posse
comitatus thing.
Posse went away. I think it was in 2009?
They also had the, right, during Katrina, they actually had the National Guard going around confiscating guns from people, too. Did you know about that?
I don't do that. I wouldn't do that. That is a complete freaking...
What would you do if you were ordered to do that? I want to bring it back here, Josh. What would you do if your commanding officer ordered you to go around confiscating guns from people in the United States? More coming up, because it happened. It's Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth slide into a recession or, at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common-sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
From 1941, when an amoeba became the first single-celled organism to play professional baseball, to 1794, when Thomas Jefferson more than likely did something historically significant, The Onion looks back at this week in history. On May 25, 1925, Tennessee teacher John T. Scopes was formally indicted for teaching the theory of evolution in a public school after a monkey called to the stand failed to turn into a human.
Sir, you have been on the witness stand for a full 3 hours now. And in this time, we haven't seen you lose any of your hair or shed your tail. Can you at least articulate a single justifiable reason why Mr. Darwin's theory should even be mentioned in our nation's classrooms?
And on May 27th, 1995, actor Christopher Reeve came in last place in a horseback riding event.
This is the Onion News Network.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
LRN.FM needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. You can bring up whatever you want here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And next weekend, we're going to be in Austin, Texas at the Texas Bitcoin Conference, the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference. And there are going to be some great speakers at this event. George Gilder, who is a world-famous investor, economist, and author, plus Sambala Nair, IBM's architect of their blockchain technology. Other great speakers, including David Johnston, Jason King, Robert Murphy, Anthony DiOrio, and Charlie Schrem, the first Bitcoin felon, as he is calling himself. We'll see what he has to say before he's checking into federal prison just a few weeks later, from what I understand. TexasBitcoinConference.com. Go there, grab your tickets, and use code FTL to get a $25 discount off the already affordable $150 admission price. So again, code FTL at TexasBitcoinConference.com. And also, when you're there, don't miss the second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. There were some really cool Bitcoin ideas that came out of last year's hackathon, and I expect the same will happen this time around. So we're looking forward to bringing the event to you, as we'll be broadcasting live, but we also look forward to meeting you there. It's this next weekend coming up, March 28th and 29th, at the Moody Theater in downtown Austin, Texas. TexasBitcoinConference.com, code FTL. As we go back to Josh in Indianapolis, Josh, I want to play a clip for you here from Hurricane Katrina, which you said you joined the military shortly after. because you wanted to assist with the National Guard. And this clip actually will reveal to you what we were saying is absolutely true, that the National Guard was being used to go and take guns. So just listen for a moment, and then we'll talk to you about it.
Today in New Orleans, they got a lot tougher on the holdouts.
Police department, you're home!
Not only the flooded areas, but New Orleans' driest and wealthiest neighborhoods, too.
Police department!
The police and National Guard going street by street, house to house.
We need to make sure, too, that whenever we knock on the doors, people refuse to leave. We need to make note, call it in.
They say there are no orders to use force, just strong persuasion, sometimes entering open houses with guns drawn, and instructions to disarm anyone inside.
You said guns will be taken?
Yeah, no one will be able to be armed. We will take all weapons. Sir.
That happened today in this wealthy neighborhood where homeowners had armed themselves to protect their mansions. Residents were handcuffed on the ground. In the end, police took their weapons but let them stay in their homes.
They were a little bit threatened because our weapons were bigger than their weapons.
For many of the police and guard troops, it is an uncomfortable job to do this in an American city. This guard unit occupied a church, using it as a base camp. They had to leave a note because they could not get hold of the pastor to get permission.
It is surreal. Yeah, you never expect to do this in your own country.
Chris Montgomery says he'd rather be in Iraq than patrolling American neighborhoods.
Walking up and down these streets, you don't want to think about the stuff that you're going to have to do. Somebody pops around the corner.
You mean shoot an American?
Yeah.
Okay, Josh. So there you go. National Guard going house to house, taking people's firearms from them. What would happen if you were told to do that?
Well, see, that's what I said. Does your boss ask you to do things you don't agree with?
I don't have a boss.
I'm my own boss.
You're your own boss.
Well, my wife tells me lots of things to do. Okay. I've got a wife.
Why I bring this up is because it's a special case scenario, okay? Number one, I don't know all the details of why it was done. I don't know what the dangers of the citizens having the guns were. It was probably the fact that they were looting and robbing everyone around there.
They said they were taking them from rich people in their mansions, too.
No, they were going house to house. They weren't just taking guns from robbers. They weren't just taking guns from robbers. They were going house to house, taking guns from everyone in a very wealthy neighborhood.
Right, you have to protect the people that are doing the most good, right?
Huh?
I don't understand.
So basically you're saying you would go ahead and take guns from people.
When does the Second Amendment stop?
If it is threatening me, yes.
So the people in their homes, just to be clear, the people in their homes were threatening?
That's not the point. The point, they're not threatening me. Why would I go do something if it completely disagrees with what I morally stand with? Then I won't do it.
Okay, so you would refuse to follow an order that you found to be disagreeable?
It obviously didn't blend with any sort of moral base, yes.
What would it look like when you tell your commanding officer, no, I will not go confiscate guns from Americans? Because we've had a lot of servicemen and women call in.
There has to be a good reason why they were doing that. And if they don't have a good reason why they were doing
There's always a good reason to set the Constitution on fire, my friend.
The reason was...
Every reason's been awesome.
I remember the excuse. The reason,
but it was a special case scenario.
Do you want to know what the reason was that I heard? The reason was supposedly claimed that someone was shooting at some police helicopter.
Okay.
So, because someone was allegedly shooting at a helicopter, that means take everyone's guns, right? Is that good enough for you?
That's a horrible reason.
Okay, so you wouldn't do it then.
Not good enough for me.
Okay, good. I'm glad to hear that you actually have...
Morally wrong.
Yeah. I'm glad that you actually have a moral code and that you would actually, be willing to utilize that moral code even when being ordered... By a commanding
officer.
I like
the idea, but there's a lot of people that were in the National Guard that didn't have that moral code, or at the very least couldn't stand up at that moment.
There were at least...
You're saying there's bad people. Oh, I know there's bad people, and there's people that don't have that code. But then again, they've gotten these people that are, 18, 19, 20 years old. Mm. They don't know what right from wrong is at some point. They have to learn that.
So you have some of the same concerns that I do.
What is the worst case scenario?
Well, wasn't your concern when you called in that we were talking about young people being brainwashed into going into the military?
No, my concern was your thought that the fact that you think everyone's being brainwashed to join the military.
In the public schools?
I didn't get brainwashed to join the military.
I understand you didn't get brainwashed to join the military. I've also pointed out...
And there's a lot of other people that are like me.
What's that?
There are also good things that come out of the military.
I don't know what that would be, though. I mean, you can get, if you're talking about, when you say good things come out of the military, if you're talking about, like, someone learning discipline or, you know, cleaning a latrine or something like that, then, you know, those are all things that can be learned without having
a lot of other things that come out of the military. Obviously, you've never served.
Yeah, thank goodness.
Serve politicians.
Yeah, serving politicians.
Serve's fine. It's just so long as we're clear that you're serving politicians.
Obviously, you know, if people need to learn discipline,
there. I thought for a second that I was serving you.
You're not. Please. No. Please, if you're serving me,
please
quit today.
Yeah. Thanks for the call, Josh. I appreciate it. I want nothing to do with the military, and I want nothing to do with politicians, the federal government. I don't want their service. I don't want their product. I don't want anything that they are offering. I don't need it. I don't need
it. It's all about fear.
Yeah, I'm not scared. I don't feel like I need the military to protect me because I think the military puts me in greater danger by virtue of the fact that they're going around the world killing people.
Well, I think that they're employed in that fashion. I don't think that the military itself does that, and the people that are in it don't want to do that. But ultimately, that's how they're being employed. Now, I don't know who to blame for that. It's not my intention to blame regular soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marines. But ultimately, you know, I mean, it's that's how they're being employed.
All right. Michael's in Virginia Beach. You're on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, you've just given me a little bit of time, even though I've been on holding for an hour and 25 minutes.
All right. Are you going to complain or are you going to get to your point?
At the 45-minute point, I heard Chris from Wisconsin say she'd been waiting for 20 minutes. So,
if you're just going to complain, I'll just get rid of you now. How about that, Michael? Do you want to make a point?
This is the point and my question. The point of my question is this. I have listened to your show for 4 years. Tonight was the first time I ever heard you mention that the show is owned by a church. The question is, principles of honest broadcasting, can we talk about it at length like you did with that witch Angela and that idiot Tony?
Thanks for the call, Michael. We don't need to be calling names here. We'll come back with more in moments. It's Free Talk Live.
The Clean and Green sale continues at Guns80.com. My buddy Mark is rolling in clover since Guns80.com announced its Clean and Green sale. He used his leprechaun-like magical powers to get Guns80.com to offer us a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. Now, for a limited time, when you order an AR-15 rifle kit, Guns80.com will toss in a cleaning kit and a tactical bipod pistol grip free, all for the low, low price of $449.95. Go to Guns80.com or call 844-2-GUNS80.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Antiwar, pro-free market. That's Antiwar.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308.
It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the road to freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free here, 855-450-FREE, and bring up whatever you want. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we have waiting for you. Now, it's an open phone show, and Saturday nights are our biggest night. We have, as I mentioned, we do the show 7 nights a week, and Saturday is the night that we have the most radio stations carrying us live in larger markets. So we have more listeners Saturday than any other night of the week. And so therefore, we have greater response on the phones when that happens. And we had a couple callers, including the last caller, complain. As soon as I took the call, they started complaining about how long they'd been waiting to get on the show. And I'm almost of a mindset, Mark, to just hang up on somebody that's going to complain about that because, really, look, let me lay this out for you here. Talk radio generally is not an open phones thing. Generally, talk shows will not just allow you to call in about any old topic you want. Sometimes you'll find a show that will have, like, an open phones hour once a week or maybe an open phones day once a week. Free Talk Live's open phones all the time. And so also... Even when they don't have open phones on these other shows, when they have a topic, if you call in and you know you have a point that you want to make that they don't want to hear, you know, let's say you're on the opposite side of an issue and they don't know how to handle whatever the point is that you want to make, their phone screener will try to ferret out all of the information that you're going to be talking about when you get on the air. And if you don't make the cut, if you don't have the perspective that they want to hear you say, you're not even going to make it on the air. You're not even going to be able to hold and wait to get on the air. So most shows, you don't get on the air at all. On Free Talk Live, if it's a busy night on the phones and you're a known caller, if we know who you are, and we certainly know who Michael is in Virginia Beach, as he said, he's been listening to the show for 4 years. He's also been calling for those 4 years. The rules of Free Talk Live are fairly simple. We want to get voices on the air who we haven't heard from first, primarily. And so, therefore, I'm more likely to take calls from people who've never been on before, or at the very least, who I don't recognize as being a caller that is an immediately known quantity. That's not to say I don't appreciate getting calls from people who we know or that, you know, we know of, that we're familiar with. It's just that they're not going to come first. And if you've got a problem with it, bitching about it isn't going to make it more likely that I'm going to take your phone call.
Well, it's certainly not an interesting conversation.
The complaining about it? Yeah. And then as soon as he's done complaining, he starts calling names. He calls Angela Keaton a witch and seems to have a problem with the fact that the Shire Free Church is behind the show. Mark, you and I, we are ministers with said Shire Free Church.
Yep.
And anyone who wants to learn more about that can go to church.shiresociety.com. So we go back to your calls here and talk to Adam in Bridgewater, Massachusetts. You're on Free Talk Live. Adam.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
What's on your mind?
Big fan of the show. Called on a few times. I just wanted to chime in. I know there's a lot of military guys calling in earlier, and they're kind of against your viewpoints. And I'm a Navy combat veteran, and I've been on 4 deployments. And there was recently a quote that I read on Reddit on Our Politics. It was actually deleted, and it really struck a chord with me, and I think it's kind of in line with what you guys are kind of talking about, and that quote was, "You grow up wanting to be Luke Skywalker, then you realize you've become a stormtrooper for the Empire."
Ooh.
And I'll admit that I was a brainwashed teenager. I joined the military. I went to boot camp a month right after high school in 2004. And I think it was in the military when I kind of realized that I was a libertarian and what I was doing was wrong. And so I kind of got out instead of re-enlisting. And I don't want to, like, drag on. I know there's a lot of callers on, so...
I would have gone to the military, too, if it hadn't been for the fact that I was, got convicted of a felony. That's really what stopped it for me. I think that this is relatively common. I hope that it doesn't sound like today that I'm calling, Army, Navy, Air Force, Marine, veterans, a bunch of idiots. That's not what my intention is. But I will say we've all been duped, that these wars largely are about profits from a ruling class. This is what Smedley Butler, whom the Marines still say goodnight to, the two-time Medal of Honor winner, maybe three. There was a third time that he almost won it. He would have if he wouldn't have been an officer. It was only
highly decorated.
Yeah, highly decorated guy.
I think he got the officer version of the Medal of Honor. They have a different version of it.
Yeah, at the time, and there were different rules at the in that time frame pre World War II. But yeah, I mean, this is a viewpoint that has very common in U.S. history. It's really just since the whole terrorist thing going on that the military has been there's been a lot of hype about it.
I'd just like to compliment you, Adam. It's true bravery in my mind to be able to admit when one is wrong, and you've done that. So thank you for that.
All right. Thank you guys speaking the truth.
Yeah. Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate that. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Jed is in Denver, Colorado. Hello, Jed.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
What's on your mind? Go ahead.
I'm just amazed with the denial of people concerning whether it be what the military actually does or how laws and people in magic robes really screw over our lives. It's amazing. And I truly believe that people in North Korea are more free than Americans are.
Whoa.
Why would you say
that's a hell of a claim?
Yeah, because when they wake up in the morning, they know they're screwed and they realize it.
I don't know if that's true. I don't know if that's true. At least not for all North Koreans. There certainly are some who are aware of the scam that's going on in that country. But
I just want food at that point.
Many of them are very, very brainwashed over there. So there's as many people brainwashed there likely as there are here in the United States.
I'm going to go ahead and say that the Heritage Foundation, the Fraser Institute, and these other organizations that do the Free the World charts show the United States at somewhere between 10 and 20 freest countries in the world, and sliding down the chart, that sadly that's probably the reality.
North Korea is usually at the bottom of that chart,
zero.
By the way.
Yeah, like it's the very last.
I can appreciate where you're coming from, Jed, but it's not... Yeah,
you're not getting anything from us on that one.
Yeah, I'm not
okay. One last thing, and then I'll go.
Okay.
The common problem with all these different situations is that words on paper that we consider law... It screws everybody in the end. And I think history shows it time and time again that when someone says, "Hey, I have power over you because me and 10 of my buddies said so, and here's a piece of paper," it never will ever work out for your benefit.
Well, mostly they say that they have power over you for your own benefit. There's always the the allure of whatever the benefit is that you're going to get. So, my biggest problem isn't that we don't need government. I think we need government. I think that really the issue is that what we don't need is an organization that claims a monopoly on this. Because when you can't switch, there's no reason that governments need to be tied to land. They're just organizations that provide protection. They don't need to be tied to land. Security organizations like Wackenhut don't have their own land, but they can still provide security.
Jed, thanks for the call tonight. I do appreciate it. Let's talk to Bill, listening in Indianapolis to WIBC. Hello, Bill.
Hello.
Hey, hi. What's going on, Bill?
Hello.
Go ahead, sir.
Not too much. Every so often I'll watch Alex Jones on YouTube. I'm sure you guys have heard of him.
Yep. He's called the show.
And, you know, on YouTube, how, like, on the right side, there'll be related videos
yep.
to what you're looking at. The other day, I saw one that talked about, like, a comet going to hit the Earth in September. And I was, like, being all specific, and then it opened up a crap ton of more videos about it. I mean, what's your guys' take on that? I know this ain't about the military and all, but I was just wondering what you guys thought about that.
I'm willing to bet everything I own that it won't hit.
I know. Well, there's always something looming on the horizon of death yep. and destruction, but I didn't know.
If the comet misses, there will be next year, there will also be some celestial body that we will be threatened by somebody who will say that, you know, asteroid, planet X, whatever it is that they're going to say is going to be coming. And at some point, they'll be right, but it'll probably be tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of years from now.
Bill, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate it. Appreciate hearing from you tonight. 855-450-FREE. We may have time for you if you're already on the line. If not, we do the show 7 nights a week. So call us any old night. If you've had trouble getting on tonight, we've always got a lot more room on weeknights and even Sundays as well. So one more segment remains. Enough time for you. The toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Perhaps it's Free Talk Live.
How fast are new Allegra gel caps?
I didn't know you got a cap fast.
How strong are new Allegra gel caps?
10 more lots to go strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gives you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms in just 1 hour. 2 times faster than Claritin and stays strong for 24 hours.
It's relief when the pollen's off the charts strong, even in the convertible.
New Allegra gel caps. Nothing's faster. Nothing's stronger. Guaranteed or your money back. Visit Allegra.com. Use only as directed.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your product and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
Hey guys, Mark Claire here, lionsofliberty.com, where we strive to advance the ideas of liberty daily. We bring you The Morning Roar! That's right, every Monday to Friday we'll have a brand new edition of The Morning Roar, where we provide a roundup of some news stories that you may not find in the mainstream media or even in your typical social media news feed. We find stories that relate to the ideas of liberty and provide you with our liberty perspective on them. Every Monday, we have our longest-running feature, Mondays with Murray, named after the great libertarian Murray Rothbard, where we'll examine an article or an excerpt from his works and help convey his view, along with our little spin as well. We wrap it all up every Friday with Felony Friday, where our own John Odermatt goes out and takes a look at some sort of felony. There's felonies committed every day, you know, whether it's a felony committed by the police, a politician, or even an average citizen. You can find all of this and so much more over at lionsofliberty.com. Advancing the ideas of liberty daily.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Moments remain, but maybe enough time for you. If you get on right now at 855-450-FREE, that's 855-450-3733. We're going to go right back into your calls, but I want to let you know about the fundraiser that is going on. Just mentioned it for the first time last night, and it's actually been going for about 3 days at this point. We're actually, surprisingly, got a big donation a moment ago. We're at 4% of the goal of $22,000. And what does $22,000 buy? Well, it buys 3 years worth of broadcasting 24 hours a day over satellite to a good swath of Africa, probably most of Africa. I mean, it's a big continent.
Oh, yeah.
And the signal that we were on prior to February 18th when we were pulled off the air was a very good signal, and we had listeners in at least in Cameroon, Africa, as well as I think I had a guy from, I think it was Ghana, contact me. Maybe it was Ethiopia. Anyway, a few different places where people have at the very least let us know they're tuned in via our free-to-air satellite feed, which unfortunately was pulled off the air. We'd been getting it for free for about 3 years, actually almost three whole years on for no charge, which, you know, you don't look a gift horse in the mouth. I certainly appreciate what was done. I knew it wasn't going to last forever, and last month they pulled us. So we've actually been off the air in Africa for about a month, and I'd really like to get back on. I think it's important to bring the ideas of liberty, especially to less free places on Earth, and some of those African nations are some of the least free places in the world.
They've got all the government that they need.
Yeah, and they have very little internet access too, and that's why the free-to-air satellite is so important, because it reaches people who don't have internet access. You know, you and I, we're used to internet. We take it for granted. But there's about 4 billion people in the world, actually the majority of the world, that has no access to the internet. So we can give them ideas of liberty through the satellite feed, and that's what we're raising money for over at africa.lrn.fm. You go to that website, it'll take you to Indiegogo. It'll take you to our fundraiser there where you get the, you know, the detailed pitch. We got a fancy video that you can watch. It'll only take you about 4 minutes of your time to watch the video and get an idea for what's going on here. But we've got about 2 months in which to raise this money. I think it's possible. We've never done anything like this before. So if you want to help us out with that, please, you can do it, you know, whatever amount of donation you want to. There's some perks involved. And actually, one of the coolest perks, kind of a high-dollar perk, but you donate a fairly high amount of money and you can come into a variety of different liberty-oriented shows, studios. You pick one, pick your favorite show. Free Talk Live is in the list, but there are several of them that have sort of stepped up and said, yeah, I'd be happy to have someone come hang out in the studio while we produce the show. So that's one of the perks available over at africa.lrn.fm, and really appreciate anyone who supports this. That's africa.lrn.fm. Let's go back to your calls and thoughts. Let's go first to Steve in Wisconsin. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Steve.
Good evening. I have 4 questions for you people.
We got a time for one question tonight, Steve, but we've got 7 nights a week if you'd like to call us any night.
All right. Yeah. I'll be quick.
Okay.
First, you're both ministers?
Yes, sir.
Of what church?
The Shire Free Church.
All right.
The term I like to use is talk show host, but yeah.
These are actually pretty quick questions. I'll let you go to number 3.
Okay,
go ahead.
3. Do you believe that the Armageddon is right around the corner?
No, absolutely.
Thank you for the
not.
Call, Steve. You can call us any night with question number 4. We're here 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 at night Eastern Time.
God is not going to destroy his creations.
Let's continue here. We've got Jeremy listening in West Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live.
If God's not going to destroy his creations, how do you explain the Ice Age? How you explain the fire and the brimstone? How you explain most of the Old Testament? I mean,
I don't explain the Old Testament. I don't even think it's history.
Yeah, we don't follow. I mean, I don't personally use the Bible as a holy book. It's just yet another book with some prophecy in it, in my opinion. Jeremy, thanks for the call. Let's go to Jason, or Temper, rather. Temper, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, I wanted to bring up American Sniper.
The movie, okay.
Yeah, there's a part in there. This is kind of a spoiler, but it's not really, you know, part of the plot.
It's been out for a long time. I don't think you have to give a spoiler alert on that.
Yeah, so it's always a good thing to give a spoiler alert. Go ahead.
So there's a part where, you know, Chris Kyle has got, you know, a mother and a child and his sights, and he shoots, I'm going to guess, like an 8-year-old boy. And his spotter goes, bad word, that was gnarly. And I think I left at that point.
Wow, you actually got up and left the theater?
Yeah, that was just, it was too much for me, man.
Wow.
It was just, how can you say that?
Well,
you just are callous to human life, essentially, at that point?
Well, I mean, as a soldier, that's what you're going to have to be able to do in order to keep your sanity. I saw the whole movie start to finish, and I'm not going to call it an anti-war movie, but I wouldn't call it a pro-war movie either.
Thank you for the call tonight. I do appreciate it. Let's continue here. We've got actually more calls on Skype. Trey is on the line in Portland. Trey, go ahead.
Hey, guys. So, you know, I live 4 hours away from Seattle, and the impending $15, what do we call that, minimum wage, is going to happen soon. And the conversations I've been having is basically with people is trying to talk out how to make a high wage more voluntary. And you and I, we all kind of disagree with taxes, you know, anyway. But if they're going to be there, in my mind, make it more voluntary and to encourage businesses to pay higher wages, it would seem feasible to me to give them big tax breaks to encourage them to be able to, like, pay higher wages, hire people on, keep people on, because, you know, if they're forced to do it, that's as high as those people are going to make. $15 is as high as a normal person's going to go. It removes competitiveness among workers. And I mean, basically, that's it. So if it's voluntary, you can always go higher with a company, I think, if something they're doing is of their own volition.
Yeah,
I'm fine with cutting taxes for people, but I don't know. You know, it doesn't seem like there should be a qualification for it. But I'm generally fine with any idea that that cuts taxes. If I were to do implement a minimum wage, I'd be more likely to implement it based on the size of the company, because people seem to really hate big companies, really successful organizations. It's the mom and pop places that are going to suffer the most from this minimum wage.
Yeah, that's true. Trey, well, any
that's
other
my
thoughts?
That's my main point, is that the people who are going to suffer the most are the mom and pops, the small businesses, because people think business owners, and they automatically think that they have, like, you know, crap ton of money stored away in a bank somewhere, and they just don't. But anyway, no, that was it.
Certainly true. Trey, thank you for the call. That's absolutely true. You know, mom and pop businesses, a lot of times they're just barely scraping by, just, you know, barely making the bills at the end of the month. Liberty Phoenix is on the line. And Keen, go ahead.
Hey, guys. You know, there's a lot of cognitive dissonance being called in tonight. With the woman that was just not wanting to hear anything that she didn't already agree with, to the gentleman, to the military individuals. You know, my whole crux of the call tonight is, you know, if you're not willing to question your own beliefs, if you're not willing to ask yourself, can I be wrong? How can you believe anything that you believe? If you're not willing to question yourself, don't sit there and judge other people. You know, and I was in the Marine Corps. I was gung-ho. I loved it. My father was a Marine. And throughout my time, I started realizing what exactly was going on. And there came to a point where I just couldn't physically do it anymore. There was one day when I put my uniform on and I physically was sick to my stomach. Mm. I called my corporal and I said, yeah, I'm not coming in anymore. I'm just done.
Really?
And I haven't been back in over a year. And
wow. Were you discharged?
Wonderful. No.
So you're AWOL? Just, you know, what is your current status?
Yeah, essentially.
No, you're not AWOL unless you get rid of your uniform. Yeah, it's absent without leave.
Unauthorized absence. Okay, so they're not doing anything to you about this?
As far as I know, no.
All kinds of stories. We've had all kinds of stories of people leaving in this manner.
It's true. It's always interesting when I hear another one.
Because you're always taught that, this is a prison sentence.
Yeah. Hey, thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate your story, Liberty Phoenix. We've got Michael on the line in Virginia Beach, who claims he's a different Michael. Go ahead, Michael.
Yes.
Same Michael.
Anti-war. Yeah. I think the question is...
You can't let him go.
Are we anti-war before war breaks out or after war breaks out?
I am anti-war all the time. Now, Michael, you broke the rules tonight, and you need to start only one call per night. It's a very simple rule. We do the show 7 nights a week. Yep, goodbye. We have one call per night. That's a simple rule, right? And the reason why we have that rule is because we want to make room for more voices. We want more people to have the opportunity to be heard here on Free Talk Live.
Then again, there wasn't anybody waiting on the line.
That's why I let him stay just for that little bit because, I did give him short shrift before, but it was only because he kept complaining about how long he had to wait on hold. And maybe we should come up with a no complaining rule.
No, I don't think that. I think that's pretty tyrannical.
A no holding, no hold time complaint rule.
Nope. Just don't expect to stay on the air long if you're going to do
it. That's true. All right, we're out of time for tonight. But you know what? If you didn't get in tonight, you can always call tomorrow. We'll be here live for the Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. 7 to 10 at night, Eastern Time, 7 nights a week. And don't forget our African satellite fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Have a great weekend.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are 1, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 19th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,165, down $10. Silver opened at $15.92, down 7 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $259.50. Today's Bitcoin price is brought to you by Express Coin, the fastest, most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. In the news, officials with the U.S. government have announced they cannot find more than $500 million worth of U.S. military aid given to Yemen. The Pentagon admitted to losing the whereabouts of small arms, ammunition, night vision goggles, patrol boats, vehicles, and other equipment provided by the U.S. Members of Congress have been attending closed-door meetings with military officials in an attempt to hold someone accountable. The Pentagon has suspended all shipments to Yemen. According to a review of federal data, the Obama administration has set a new record for censoring files or blocking access under the U.S. Freedom of Information Act. The Associated Press studied requests to 100 federal agencies during 2014. They found an administration that takes long periods of time to respond to requests and often claimed no records existed or refused to release records until they were challenged in court. The U.S. government spent about $28 million on lawyers' fees to keep records secret. Nearly 40% of all requests were denied. Protesters with the Blockupy Alliance battled with riot police early Wednesday in Frankfurt, Germany, at the opening of a new headquarters for the European Central Bank. An estimated 7,000 people rallied and fought with the police, who threw tear gas and fired a water cannon. Around 550 protesters were detained, 94 police officers were injured by stones, and 7 police cars were set on fire. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from CoinArch, offering innovative trading solutions for Bitcoin. Do more than just buy and sell Bitcoin. Use long and short positions to profit in rising and falling markets and boost your returns through leverage. Visit CoinArch.com and sign up using coupon code MAX and get free brokerage for the first 7 days. Looking to promote your business or cause to tens of thousands of loyal listeners? Well, for a limited time only, the Liberty Beat is offering you the chance to say big while spreading your message. It's simple. Just sign up for 3 months of advertising and get your 4th month free. Don't miss out on this unique opportunity. Just visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise and use coupon code GCN in the Describe Your Company section. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 19th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. On Wednesday, a group of parents of the 43 missing Mexican students appeared in Houston as part of a tour across the United States. Protesters gathered with the families outside of Houston's Mexican consulate, holding signs and chanting. The protest was in solidarity with the families, who have not seen their children since they went missing in September of last year. The parents are planning to travel to New York on April 28th to ask the United Nations to investigate the human rights violations in Mexico. Law enforcement and government officials have been suspected of working with local gangs to murder the students. Researchers in Brazil have published a long-term study in the Lancet Global Health Journal that claims breastfed babies are more likely to turn into well-educated and higher-learning adults. The researchers from Brazil's Federal University of Pelotas followed close to 6,000 babies from birth into their 30s. Around 3,500 of the participants volunteered to be interviewed and take IQ tests. All of the babies who had been breastfed were of higher intelligence, had spent more time in school, and earned higher wages. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support also comes from the Texas Bitcoin Conference. Hear from speakers like Charlie Trim, Dr. Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, and Catherine Bleich, March 28th and 29th at ACL Live at the Moody Theater. Tickets on sale now at TexasBitcoinConference.com. Use coupon code LibertyBeat for $25 off your ticket. That's coupon code LibertyBeat. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 19th, 2015. Remember to check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
After logging onto the Xbox One game console at one of his classmates' homes, 12-year-old Michael Cutler admitted to reporters this week that he really does not have the slightest clue about what his friend's name could be.
I mean, his name might be Brian. No, wait, Brian's my other friend, the one with the PS4. Yeah, if I'm being totally honest, there's no way I can tell you his name. Not a chance.
Noting that the boy had, quote, an absolutely huge HDTV and a bunch of games his mom won't let him play, Cutler confirmed that he could